Hello, people. How's everybody doing tonight? Seventh and Second here. Oh, boy. Today's been one of them days. I felt so fucking lazy. There was part of me that just didn't even want to stream. But then I'm like, no, I had shit I wanted to do today. So we did a lot of stuff. A lot of it was cooking related, surprisingly. I tried out a few things. I tried out, let me turn the music down, because holy shit, it is loud as shit. Oh no, yeah, no. I love this Necrodancer shirt. Are you kidding me? Look at this thing. This thing is beauteous. By the way, this is one of their official shirts. Go pick it up if you like the game and you want to support them and you like a nice shirt, because this is nice and soft. Oh god. It's so soft. But yeah, today was something that was like, okay, I've had these packs of, like, rice noodles for the longest time. I don't even remember when I bought them. It was that long ago. It was just dried rice noodles ready to be prepared. Three packs of them, decent amount of them. Shokin Flora, Infiora, no. No. Come on. Give me something a little bit more upbeat. Yeah, sure, Family Jewels has got my back. Oh. Yeah, no, I have something I gotta work at, I gotta look into for work when I get into work on Monday, but I have my time on the weekend where I don't think about work, and then I go into work and I do my work. But I decided sometime yesterday that I was going to make put in some time and figure out how to cook these rice noodles that I've had for the longest time correctly. And I think I got it right the first time, which is a little strange because the past couple times I've tried to cook stuff, it hasn't been right the first time. This was soaking them in water for 15 minutes, then boiling them for 2 or 3 minutes, and then draining them, and then frying them with some oil and if you were here yesterday or Thursday, you saw the Korean sauce I had. I basically poured a bunch of that in there and sauteed it up with that. So I think it went pretty well. It didn't have a super strong taste on the noodles, but that they weren't the point. They were supposed to be a side dish. They were supposed to go with whatever else I was eating. A little bit left over of what the last thing I was eating. But yes, they went really well. And I have a bunch left over, so I can have some more of them as a side with something else. So... And now that I know that, I have two other packs of rice noodles that are basically waiting for me to do stuff. Now, the other thing, I gotta find, it's Asian, I think it's this website? Yes. Wait, do I? No, I did pull that out. Cool. For a second, I didn't think I did. I'm gonna find the thing that one of my friends is gonna be showing me. These things. Uh, So, well, actually, it's over there now. I forgot I moved where chat was. So those things are a noodle type that one of my coworkers absolutely loves. And he was talking to me about it. And I'm like, oh, that doesn't sound pretty. I don't think I've had those noodles before. Usually Asian noodles are really good. So if you've got a set that you're willing to let me have to try, then sure, yeah, we'll go with it. And he is. So he's going to bring me a set of those noodles to cook. And if you read the description, it just sounds fucking weird. But, like, I think it's the specific type of thing. Okay, they don't actually mention it in this, but the Wikipedia article for these type of noodles is just weird. But yeah. So we were good. I cooked that. I got a little bit more stuff done today. And then... I think when I was last done in the kitchen, I think I ended up leaving the Bluetooth speaker on. Because I have this little, like, Bluetooth speaker for having louder sound in the kitchen when I'm cooking or when I'm eating or when I'm cleaning dishes or doing anything in the kitchen. Or hell, anything in the apartment where I need. Because my tablet doesn't have good speakers. They are not loud, not even in the slightest. So I bought this thing, and I'll even pull it over because it's right here. This thing. Nice, concise Bluetooth speaker. I left it on when I was leaving the room, or when I was coming back to my room for a bit. And after a little bit, I had my door open, and I heard a noise, and I heard like a voice, and I'm like, well, that seems weird. Is it like waiting for pairing or something like that? No. It's like, hey, I'm getting low on battery. So I'm like, okay, I gotta go find the cord. Now, see the back of this thing? I don't even know if you're not gonna be able to read that all that well, not without me changing the focus, but it's basically on off, line in, SD card, and USB slot. For whatever reason in my mind, my brain equated the line in port as the power port. And I was like, fuck, where's the power cord for it? And I looked everywhere and I'm like, that doesn't make any sense. And then I thought about it and I went, why did I think it was that? The USB slot's the power slot. So, I don't know why, I don't know how, my brain just decided, oh, fuck you, this is not what you wanted. But I figured it out really fast, thankfully, without driving myself insane. And it's plugged in and it's recharging. And I will admit, that thing has lasted like 2 or 3 months, something like that, of me using it like multiple times a week. So the battery in the damn thing is amazing. Sound is loud as fuck because my roommates have told me that they didn't know when I was using it, and they thought it was just another person in the apartment, not that I was listening to a VOD. So it's good and it's what I want. But enough about all of that. I hope you guys are doing amazing. I hope you're having a good night tonight. We are going to get into some Phoenix right here, right now. Much as I love you, Metroid. Rolling up. Objection! We have a case to finish, and then we have to get to more cases because I want to keep going. So I'll even show it because it's right here. This motherfucking tablet is perfect for me. For like when I'm working in the kitchen. If I'm in the kitchen and I'm listening to a stream, what I used to do was I used to turn the TV on out in the front area and just go from there. And the TV would, in my old apartment, the layout was that there was no big barrier between where the TV was sitting and where the kitchen was. So I could just turn the TV on and that would be my sort of outward speaker visual thing that I could use. Here in this apartment, it doesn't work nearly as well. I originally bought this thing to use it at work because they put stricter restrictions on the network at the at our internet at work, like filtering, and we can't go to sites like Twitch or YouTube. But there was still a guest network that we could connect our phones to, and a friend of mine was already doing this. I bought that tablet for like $175 or $200, something like that. It's a super cheap tablet, and I've gotten so much damn use out of this thing. Holy shit, it just paid for itself. But now, when I was in the kitchen, or before I got the speaker, when I was in the kitchen, I would pull the tablet up and set the tablet down and use the tablet. But the problem is the speakers on this thing are kind of crap. And they don't, and unfortunately, the case that it's in, because it has to be a protective case, sort of absorbs sound a bit too much. So the sound was actually kind of hard to hear sometimes, especially if you were doing a bunch of stuff, if you were doing a lot of loud stuff. Like, if you had, like, the sink running, like, the faucet running on the sink, or if, like, you were cooking something on there, or somebody was using fucking the laundry unit that's right there, you couldn't hear it. So I did a little research, found a fairly inexpensive Bluetooth speaker that I use a lot. Pretty much any time I'm in the kitchen, I use it. Neverworld Gaming, I am doing absolutely fantastic. How are you doing, man? How are things? Thank you for stopping in, man. It's good seeing you. We are about to get into some delicious Phoenix Wright. Now, we're about to do something that is really weird and is really strange. We're about to do something that only the Queen should be able to do in this country, but that's not the case. Dude, you got a job? Fuck yeah, man! That's what I want to hear! What kind of job you got, man? Where'd you land? Let me see. Alright. Because, like, getting a job, having some kind of stable income, perfect. It's exactly what you need. A DSI, oh, okay. Nice. Those things are, like, everywhere nowadays. And especially if you vape, working in a vape shop is perfect. Because you're the kind of person that is very, very easily, like, you can sell the product because you use the product and you know, you have knowledge of the product. It's perfect. So, congrats on landing that thing, man. A DSI? I wonder. I don't know. I don't know if Loopy's doing these or not. Now, the one guy that I know does not do DSI. He does not do DSI capture boards. To my knowledge, at least. It looks like he only does original model DS ones. Or you could do, I think he does 3D capture. Let me see what he actually has. My camera's in the fucking way. So, like, he does DS capture, but that's with a regular 3D. That's with, like, a regular DS. And then he does, It's hard to get one for that model, but I mean, maybe if you look around, you could find them. But the two places I know don't do those; they don't do DSIs. Like, mine was expensive because I bought I said, "Hey, buy me a new 3DS as well." I didn't send them my 3DS. There are places I could have sent them my 3DS, and it would have probably cost me half the price, but I didn't feel like doing that, partially because I was like, hey, there's this new shiny model of 3DS that I've been wanting for a while, and this was sort of an excuse to get it. And now if there's any 3DS games that I want to play that are actually, like, need the new model, it'll go better. And also, this one runs a little faster, so it's nicer. There's a little bit less load time. If I ever want to do Monster Hunter, this one's almost required. But an original model one would, but you said DSI. DSIs are different than an original 3DS, or original DS. That's the only difference. Like, there is a difference between a DS and a DSi. But I think an original model DS would work if you wanted to capture those. If you wanted a capture card for that. I can drop the spot where it's at. How much is it? Well, okay, let me rephrase that. You could buy it from this guy, but he's currently out of them. And I actually don't know if he's making... Well, okay, hang on. I'm on the wrong one. Hang on. No, he is doing them. He's got availability for it. This is the guy that, does them locally. His name's Loopy. I was sort of waiting on him to do a 3DS XL capture card, but he never did them. So I went with another, I went with the, pretty much the only other people in the game for this. It sucks. That's one of those things that's pretty much one place you could go to, the place that I got, but people, there have been reports of the cards malfunctioning. Thankfully, it's never happened to me. I've never had a problem with my capture card from these people. So you have to take it at like face value. And the other problem is that the people I bought from are in Japan, so it's a little harder to get to them for stuff. So, but either way, we can talk later about this. We can always talk about this. You can always message me on you can message me on Twitch. You can message me on Twitter if you want to talk about this. We can always talk about it later. All right. So last time, our request was we want to cross-examine the head monk. And they were like, well, nobody can do that because the queen of the country is the only person who can do it, and she's too fucking busy to do that, so we ain't doing it. And we said, well, we have somebody else who can do it. And basically, Maya needs to do this, or we die. But we have faith in Maya, don't we? We all trust Maya. She's trustworthy. All right. May 12th. High Court of Karain accused the lobby. Sorry, Maya, but this was the only way. You're sure you're up for this? Thanks for believing in me, Nick. You know, I don't know if my channeling ability is on point yet. Oh, right. She hasn't done it. Like, before she started the training here, her success rate was only about 30%. It's like, I know you can do it, Maya. At least, I hope she can. So you sure you're ready? Yeah, at least I think so. You don't sound confident. What about all your training? Training's one thing. Actually doing it is another. Oh. Yeah, I see. Uh-oh. Oh boy. I think it's just people that are in fucking proximity of anybody from the Wright Anything agency. They just get shit. Dude, that, like I said, if you vape and you need a job, go talk to a local vape shop. They probably need people who know the product and are willing to like be around people vaping all the time. I think I was at, I think it was a tournament that I was at, like a local major here in Atlanta that I was at, and the amount of people that were vaping in the crowd was to the point where it was actually starting to irritate my eyes a little bit. Or at least the people that were in the front part of the seats. So I had to move either I moved a row back or I just said, fuck it, it's not enough for me to move. I can't remember which one it was, but this was like 3 years ago, back when vaping was just starting to really come into play, and people sort of may or may not have known what was going on with that. But yeah, it's a good fit. It's a good thing that you can do, and you can be passionate about the job, so that'll help. If she fails to channel the High Priest, we're as good as dead. Relax, Nick. You can count on me. Show you what my training's done for me. Wow, I don't know why I thought that sentence was gonna go differently. This will be a moment you'll never forget. Okay. I just hope it's unforgettable in a good way. Once we hear Abbott Enmi's story, I'm sure the truth will come to light. I really hope so. But he was hiding the fact that he was a rebel, so I doubt it'll be as cut and dry as that.
They are ready for you. Please return to the Hall of Justice at once.
Okay, Maya. I'm counting on you. Well, thank you for the compliments, man. One of these days, if you make it over here to, like, if it ever works out that you make it over here to a convention, like a PAX, like, or a TwitchCon or something like that, we gotta hang out. Oh, yeah, they all have them. Like, all the guards in here have them. Because, you know, why not? You got it. Here we go. Oh, boy. This is gonna be weird. I'm sort of wondering how they're going to visualize this, if it's going to be the same way they used to visualize it, where okay, here's a question. Is he going to be wearing Maya's clothes? And is he going to have Maya's hairstyle? Because, yeah. This could get weird. May 12th, High Court of Karain.
We have received official approval for the accused to channel a spirit here today. Now, if you will, Miss Faye, please proceed.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Can't believe this! Only the Queen can channel spirits! Execute them! Put them to death right now! Death! 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 Death!
Jesus fuck. These people are super weird about this shit. I mean, I understand why. They've been basically completely told that no one in the world can do this but the Queen. And somebody's like, no, I can do it. And that's not even the problem. It's no big thing. That's gonna shake a lot of people's sort of foundations, I guess, if you're gonna call them anything. Come on, Maya. We're counting on you. Good. I've been studying here in Karain for 2 years now, so that one day, I will be the master of Karain, a village of spirit mediums back home. But first, I shall show you all the fruits of my training in your kingdom. Oh, Jesus, wow, she seems really confident all of a sudden.
A neophyte practitioner such as you could not possibly channel a spirit.
Okay, your benevolence. How about this? If I succeed, will you stop calling me a neophyte?
Very well. If you succeed.
Oh, I will. Just you watch. Here we go, boys. Oh, spirit of trust in- Oh, Jesus, fuck, I'm- Return now to the world of the living. Fuck, I can't read fast enough.
Yes! Yes! He does have her hair. He does have her clothes.
Her?
What is this place?
Oh my!
Huh? No, this cannot be.
Balkunka.
It's the high priest. The accused really can channel spirits. I don't believe it. The accused's spiritual power is the real deal.
All right, good job, Maya.
I do not understand. This cannot be.
Oh, she gonna fucking faint? Okay, no, she's not.
This simply cannot be! I must step out now before I forget myself.
You would literally lose. Sure. Okay, princess. Sure.
Abbott Enmi.
Would this be the Twilight Realm?
And what of this luxurious mane of hair?
Oh, Duddy Moonshine, we need that. That's gotta be his voice. We gotta do that. We gotta do as close to the troll voice as we can.
Is it perhaps a gift of the Holy Mother for decades of faithful service?
Abbot in me?
My, but if it isn't His Majesty, have you too shuffled off that mortal coil?
Please, do not count me among the dead. It's only you that has passed on. But the spirit medium, Maya Fey, has brought you back among us today.
Why?
Acolyte Fey has mastered the secret art of spirit channeling? I suppose that explains these gorgeous locks. When I pass from this world, I too hope to be channeled with a full head of hair.
Though it be for the briefest of moments, I give thanks for this splendid
coiffer? Is that how you say that? That's a word I've never seen before. I mean, I understand what it means. Google, how do you say that?
Coiffeur.
Coiffeur. I'm putting too much emphasis on part of the words, which is a standard practice of mine, but coiffeur. Again, never heard of that word before. Sure. Coiffeur.
Praise be to the Holy Mother. However, this kimono is a bit too snug for my taste. If you would excuse me.
This hasn't actually been discussed before. But, like, I'm pretty sure that's his body, right? I'm almost certain it's their body, but, like, her hair and her clothes. That was always the way it was. It's like, every time you've ever seen Spirit Channel, it's all the hair and the clothes stay the same, but the body changes. The body is a physical change. What happens if they just... Like... What happens if she popped... Phoenix Wright, this game is not going to go full fan service on that. They're not. But it... I wouldn't put it past them. Let's just say I'm expecting something to force him to put his clothes back on before they pop him out of Maya's body. Or before they pop him out of Maya's... Was that her body? Her... Before they cancel the channeling technique is probably the proper way to look at it, but sure.
There, that is better.
Could we get to his testimony now? I wish he kept his top on.
Huh? Why, you are that foreign lawyer the people speak of as of late. And is this not the Hall of Justice? Why have I been summoned here?
Forgive us for calling you back from your eternal rest. But you have been accused of murder. Might we ask you to testify on your own behalf?
Joints don't work that way? I mean, maybe his do, but fuck. We're fucking, we have Stretch Armstrong on the bench now. Holy shit.
I have been accused of murder. That is troubling indeed.
What is with that crazy pose?
Is this really cause for such astonishment? Even the lowliest of monks can achieve such body control with proper training.
I wonder if Albi will be able to do that someday.
Will the defense please explain the situation to the High Priest?
I'd be happy to. Your disciple, Praise-A-Lot, has been murdered. It happened on the day before the purification rite. And the crime occurred in the rebel hideout hidden within the Inner Sanctum.
Acolyte Zealot? He has been killed? Who would do such a thing?
Someone who knew of the hideout and had access to the Inner Sanctum. In other words, you, Abbot Inmi, after all. Weren't you secretly a rebel?
Oh, Jesus, he's getting weirder.
I mean, that one's not necessarily the word. Okay. The leg and the left arm. Not amazingly weird. The fucking right arm, the one behind his back. Whoa, that's some like triple jointed bullshit that I don't even want to deal with. Oh dear. That's still Maya's body. I hope he doesn't break anything.
Who?
Wow, the High Priest is amazing. I think he'd master such an advanced prayer pose.
He's still worthy of our veneration, even if he is a rebel.
Praise be to the Holy Mother! Praise be to the Holy Mother! Oh my. No, wait, that's not his voice. Oh my.
Have my rebel allegiances been exposed? Not even my wife knew of that. It seems to rest in peace is not my fate.
Why did you, a devout purist of Quranism, join the rebellion?
The High Priest has come back to us, but for a brief time, Defense. Shall we not cut to the chase and ask the most pressing of questions?
Oh, right. I gotta split that into two parts. Because that is one wall of text is just a little annoying. And it's not like it's unknown that clips are available in all channels. I actually think I'm gonna fix that right now. All right, there we go. That's a much more manageable clip of text. I'm okay with that. I mean, clips are known at this point. Hell, I can even do them on mobile. Right.
Abbot Inmi, the prosecution believes that the one who slew both you and Acolyte Zealot to be Maya Fey, who had been playing the role of Lady Kira in the rite.
Being that I was dead until just a moment ago, my memory is a bit hazy.
Could you please do your best to remember?
Objection!
The High Priest says his memory is hazy.
It is all coming back to me now.
Or, yeah.
It is as Prosecutor Saad Mahdi concluded.
You dirty motherfucker. This is weird.
I was slain by none other than Maya Fey.
Well, one, we know you're lying, so... And I sort of know the reason why he's lying, but we're gonna have to pull it out of him. I want an official statement from you, motherfucker.
The High Priest's statement has proven my assertions with regards to his murder correct.
Well, okay, one, that's not necessarily as big of a problem right now. Exactly, Phoenix, exactly. They already think she's guilty of the one. We have to prove her innocent of the first, then we can prove her innocent of the second, then we can prove her innocent of both, but we have to... I know why, I have an idea why he's lying. I'll talk about it in a second. Once we get to the point where there's a little bit less going on, I'll talk about it in a second.
But what acolyte? But what about acolyte Zealot? You were the one who killed him, weren't you?
I knew not about my disciple's murder. Furthermore, I have an alibi of my own.
An alibi? Seriously?
It seems the testimony the defense has been hoping for is working against him. Now, evident me. Your testimony, if you please.
Yeah, we're gonna prove this motherfucker lying for reasons.
Yes, of course. I have an ironclad alibi for the time during which the murder took place. Just past noon on the day before the rite, I was entertaining guests in my home. And I believe my guest can corroborate this.
You had guests? Just past noon, that's right about the time Zealot was murdered. Are you sure about that?
Absolutely.
Come to think of it, Rafa told me about a spirit's memory.
A spirit's memory is cut off at the moment of death. So even a spirit that is brought back after centuries doesn't sense any gap in time. Between the moment of its death and the moment it's channeled?
That was Phoenix reading that, excuse me.
Yes, and yet he clearly recalls all of the memories it had in life.
I pretty seem to know exactly what he's talking about. So the question is, what would be the best angle of attack? Alright, we're gonna actually have multiple ways to do this. I mean, I'm okay with that. Alright, I want to check something because I didn't check this last time. Okay, so we're good at 4 batteries. Cool. Maybe towards the end of the cast, I'll have to make sure that I actually, you know, plug her in to make sure. Alright. You use the word alibi as if it were second nature.
Are you perhaps mocking me? Or is it perhaps the kingdom of Kurain itself you wish to ridicule?
Damn! Holy fuck! Wow! Shit! I just want to read that. Hang on. Come on, everybody and their grandma knows what an alibi means. We're not a bunch of country bumpkins here. We have plenty of courtroom dramas on TV.
Peace, I say. Mr. Wright, would you care to clarify your last statement?
Please, don't take it the wrong way. It's just, alibi is a rather technical term for a priest to use so naturally.
I assure you, I know how to use the term. In fact, I'd even hoped for a chance to do it once so one day. I suppose that even I, a high priest, am not immune to such trivial worldly attachments.
I see. Still, he seems unusually calm and composed. It's almost as if he had prepared himself for something like this. Or prepped himself for something like this. I want to ask this again, because I keep forgetting to... Like, I'm always paranoid about this. Can you guys hear my window over there? Can you hear the noises that are... Can you hear other shit coming off there that's not normally there? If you get, like... In theory, you shouldn't be able to hear anything, because the sounds of the game and my voice should actually be completely overriding what's going on over there, but... You can't hear, like, AC units kicking on, right? Cool. That's the big thing. Because, like, it really helps my room to have that window open, because it keeps the room fairly cool for me. So, it's good enough for me. Alright. It was just past noon on the day of the rite. I was entertaining guests in my home. So I'm assuming he's going to talk about this. We don't have any way to prove what time it is in this photo, I don't think. Yes, I'm fairly certain we don't have a way to prove that, but sure. Well, we'll see what he goes with. Guests? And you were entertaining them personally?
That I was. We gathered around the table for a most enjoyable conversation.
He said his guess could corroborate his alibi. It can't be good for our client. Are you sure it was the same day as the murder? Maybe you've misremembered.
Whoa. Do not doubt my
mnemonic. I wanted to pronounce the beginning of that, but it's...
Do not doubt my mnemonic faculties. I may have died, but my memories up to that point are crystal clear.
Do we have it wrong about the order of things again? No, we couldn't have... things are getting weird. Sorry. He's pretty thin-skinned for a priest. Though I guess I should have known better than to doubt his memories. We're gonna have to go through this a bunch. Please tell me we don't have to go through this a bunch. Spirit medium is cut off at the moment of death. So even a spirit... we already said this like 20 times. If we're gonna keep going to this, I'm gonna get really annoyed. Don't do... Game, I'm looking at you, game. Do not do this. Do not. Do not do. Do not pull an Apollo Justice and play that fucking clip 20 times. At least it's not... At least I can power through and I can just mash and just get through the damn thing, but not with... As long as you're not pulling an Apollo Justice, we're fine.
Ah, there's nothing better than enjoying Genjo cuisine with dear friends. That way, everyone's breath becomes equally malodorous.
Right. Who's the guest? Who they're gonna... And who exactly were your guests that day?
Don't tell me they were rebels, so they can't be called here to testify.
It was none other than His Majesty, along with his family.
Oh. What?
Okay, now they're starting to lend more credence to the idea that... we might even have the orders of these wrong. This is just fucking weird. I don't understand. Shit is just weird.
It was none other than His Majesty, along with his family. He couldn't attend the rite due to work, so he stopped by ahead of time. My, my, how his daughter had grown.
Oh, wait a second. Let me set the record straight right now.
Oh, excuse me. Let me set the record straight right now. I am not a rebel. Thank you for that wonderful meal, Abbot in me.
Hey, Judge. Judge Poo. What day did this happen? What day did this happen?
Lady Inmi's cooking is simply just cannot be beat.
I love how he has completely taken to having Maya's hair. That like, just long, flowing, really well-kept hair. I love that he's just like, no, this is perfect. I know exactly how to handle this shit. It's great.
So there you have it.
When exactly was His Majesty at your home?
He was there from 2 p.m. to 3 p.m.
Indeed. Precisely the time period from... no, it wasn't. That doesn't cover everything, fucker. Here we go. We getting him.
Indeed. Precisely the time period within which Acolyte Zealot was slain.
Yes, we had a rousing chat concerning the game... The game of Kachu Damal.
Also, since I hadn't said that literally before just now, probably in a way where I was sort of trying to pay attention to how to pronounce that, they were talking about Pokemon. Let's just be 100% clear. They were talking about Pokemon. Catch you them all? That's Pokemon. But
I'll just have that added to the testimony. After all, it was I who visited the High Priest at home.
I need you to add that to the fucking testimony, because we're gonna save. Boot, 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 boot. They're doing fun. This is what they always do. They're just like, you know what? No, let's just go balls to the wall. We have a foreign country we can play with. Let's play with it.
All right. Hold it.
Your Majesty, are you sure this testimony is completely accurate?
As sure can be. Oh, how...
That was an odd noise.
Oh, how wondrous it is to finally have my actions be admissible as evidence in court!
His Majesty was at home during the exact time period of the murder. Come, let us put this behind us. I could not have possibly committed the crime.
How can you be so sure? What if the clock or the watch you were using was off? Or you misread the time? Hey there, Jangutu. How you doing, man? It's good seeing you. Okay, I imagine, like... I imagine that this is like... It's kind of like Pokemon. How, like... In every town, there's an Officer Jenny or a Nurse Joy. Every time, every Poke Center has a Nurse Joy. I think every court has a Judgy. I think there is someone from that descendant family line in every single courtroom in the entire world. Doesn't matter where you are or who it is. There is a Judgy somewhere in your court, in your world space, somewhere in your court system, everywhere.
Ooh, what are you cooking?
So that's the question. What do you got cooking for dinner?
There was a clock right near the table, and it had the exact time, exact same time as my watch.
Now, do you understand, lawyer?
Oh, I perfectly understand, motherfucker. Wait, what? You're okay.
As you can see, my alibi is airtight. Or do you still think I could have killed Accolade Zealot?
His Majesty, he's a witness. That's not good.
Are you satisfied now? There is not a single discrepancy in Abbot Inmi's alibi.
Yeah, there is. You're just trying to push things along, motherfucker. Don't try that with me. If I give up now, it's all over.
Now, hold on a second.
Is there something, anything wrong with the High Priest testimony? I mean, I'm, like, pretty sure there is. There is a discrepancy in the High Priest testimony.
There is? Well then, perhaps you could explain what it might be.
This is what was wrong with his testimony.
That is actually extremely important that I hadn't thought about. Oh fuck. How does he know the time of the crime if he died?
We didn't find out about...
That's really important.
After Abbot Inmi was channeled, no one had ever stated what time Acolyte Zealot was murdered.
Now that you mention it...
Despite that, you claim to have an alibi from 2 to 3 p.m. That means you knew that Acolyte Zealot was dead when you were still alive.
That was actually kind of cool.
Oh, wait. I think I just saw something just now. Wait, was there actually something important? No, I must be imagining things. So tell me, how did you know what time the crime had been committed?
Oh, that's an interesting face. Oh, shit.
About that?
Hang! Open your heart! Let the Holy Mother in. What? Why, we've been blessed with the High Priest's sacred words of prayer. All who serve the Holy Mother, her holiness, must strive to banish worldly desires from their soul. Open your heart! Let the Holy Mother in! Purge your mind of greed and some other word. I feel as if my very soul has been cleansed.
You can't fool me. Prayer may banish worldly desires, but it can't make a contradiction disappear. You are not about to explain how the fuck this man knew this guy was dead.
How can you be so sure?
What is that even supposed to... Like, literally, what are you even getting at?
This lawyer seems to think little of the power... of the power of Quranist prayer.
Huh?
Nehuta,
what are you even going... No. I don't know what bullshit you're about to pull, but it's going to be bullshit.
Abbot Inmi was at home... excuse me. Abbot Inmi was at home during the time of the crime, but knew of what happened in the at the hideout. I believe this can be explained thusly. He must have a way to monitor the hideout from his home.
We didn't find anything like that in there. But sure, if you want to try to go that way, Prosecutor, we can deal with that.
You never cease to amaze, Prosecutor. As he has surmised, there was a listening device installed at the hideout. It enabled me to instantly learn of anything unusual, even when I was not there.
Remember, the rebels had been using this as a top-secret hideout. It would be perfectly natural for them to install such apparatus.
Wait, come to think of it, when I was searching the rebel hideout... Huh? There's something under this banner. A microphone? Oh, we did find that. Fuck. What's this doing here? Was someone trying to record something with it? That was a listening device?
It starts recording whenever it detects movement. And I heard such that... I heard just such a recording after His Majesty and his family left. If you look in my desk... If you look in the desk in my study, you will find the tape in question.
Can we get that? Can we listen to that?
Alright then, Bailiff! Yes, Your Majesty. Go retrieve the tape in question from the High Priest's home. At once, your Majesty.
I don't have a good way to distinguish voices for them. I'm going to have to figure something out for that.
The power of Quranist prayer. Even a putrid brain such as yours should understand it by now.
It's like the contradiction really did vanish.
We shall ascertain the contents of the recording once we have the tape. In the meantime, I would ask Abbot Inmi to continue with his testimony.
Okay.
Very well.
Okay. I heard everything.
I was entertaining His Majesty and his family when the crime occurred. When I listened to the tape later, I heard a man and a woman quarreling. It sounded like an altercation between Acolyte Zealot and Acolyte Fae. After that, there was a loud noise, followed by haunting silence.
It's still not good for us, but we have ways to get around this, I think. Pretty sure. Right? We have to. I have to find some way to attack his alibi. If only Maya were here, she'd have a way of putting me at ease. But seeing her like this is really creeping me out.
Though the High Priest was a rebel, he was still a Quranist holy man. Therefore, take care in your questioning, lest you invoke the ire of our people.
Is this gonna be one of those ones where I can't press? Because I don't like it when they tell me I can't press shit. As if this wasn't hard enough already? Nice try, but I'll stuff at nothing to find the truth.
But there.
We were gonna save just because, I don't know, in case I accidentally choose don't continue if I ever fail like that.
Hold it!
You were entertaining his majesty and his family during the crime.
Indeed. My wife, Believe, was treating them to her wonderful home cooking.
Your wife was there that day?
Why, yes. She was in the kitchen cooking up a storm the entire time.
Come to think of it, I don't think I saw her at all that day. Ah, that's important.
She takes her culinary duties most seriously. You'll see. Or you see. That is why she was in the kitchen cooking without pause the entire day.
So wait, so the judge never saw Mrs. Inme? Should I have Inme added to this testimony? I think it's kind of important, but we're going to press everything else. Please add that statement to your testimony. I don't know certain reasons of why it went down. I have ideas where it's going.
As you wish.
Alright. So we're gonna press everything.
My wife, Believe, was in the kitchen cooking this entire time.
The entire time? Okay. What was your wife making that day?
The menu that day featured?
Hatton's Surprise? And Melton Mott? Sure.
They are both Quranese dishes. Or traditional Quranese dishes.
I can't even begin to imagine what those things are.
Ah, yes. The exquisite zest of Hatton's Surprise and the supreme texture of Melton Mott.
We're gonna say Melton Mott. I definitely see that one now that I said it again. I understand it's like hot and surprise? Or surprise? Hot and spies? Something like that. I don't know what it is. Or hot and spicy? So this is supposed to be hot and spicy? Yeah, you know, I could see that. I could see that a lot for that first one.
Lady Inme's cooking that day was utterly unforgettable.
Thank you. It brings me great joy to know you enjoyed your meal. Now, once his majesty and his family had left.
Hold it!
You know, it may not actually be that that statement we added. We're gonna see here in a second. You heard everything from a recording?
Indeed. Each night, I would secretly check what the listening device had recorded. I would have been in serious trouble with my lovely wife if she had discovered my secret.
Can you really tell what happened by audio alone?
Long years of
ascetic. We did this one before. It's ascetic.
Ascetic training have sharpened my hearing. But it is. But a simple matter for me to ascertain a situation by the sounds I hear.
Practicing Quranism improves your hearing?
I don't know about that. I don't think I believe that. No, probably not.
Hearing is but one of the senses it can improve. But if one can focus and attain inner peace, all five senses can be sharpened. Why, the Warbad over in the bazaar just cried. Did you not hear it?
Give me a break. Also, I guess that his thumb is towards the inside of him, so that does actually sort of look right.
Hold it!
Let's see if they let me add something else. Hold on. Are you sure about those voices? Was it really Acolyte Zealot and Miss Faye?
I'd say it was the most reasonable conclusion under the circumstances. Or perhaps Acolyte Faye has an alibi that you can prove?
I'm afraid not.
Then I suggest you make like a mollusk and clam up. Now, I will continue my testimony if I may.
Fuck. Fuck. Fuck, 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 okay.
After that, well, we already said that.
Alright. A loud noise? I'd say that's worth looking into.
It was a terrible crashing sound. Poor Acolyte Zealot. It must have felt so heavy.
It must have been the sound of the stone slab falling over. So we have two ways that we can have him add this. So all he knows about the crime is what he heard on the tape. And he was with his magistrate and his family the entire time.
Now that I have proven the soundness of my alibi, I believe it's about time for me to return to the Twilight Realm.
What's the rush? Why not enjoy some more time among the living? I'm ready to find a way to attack his alibi soon. I'll just have to press harder and hope something useful comes out. Alright, so do we have anything that can prove that she wasn't in there the entire time? Okay, so the two ways that we can go right now are we can attack the idea that his wife might not have been there the entire time, or we can look at it and go, how did you know what was happening with the sounds? You know what? Let's put that other statement in. Oh, fuck. That wasn't what I wanted to do. I didn't mean to go that far. All right, so let's have him put the other statement in.
Hold it!
This may be something that, like, we can have both statements in. Yeah, go ahead and add it. If it lets me add them both and keep them both, then there's no reason not to. Please add that statement to your testimony.
As you wish.
All right, do we have six or do we still have five? We have six. Okay, so we actually have both statements in there. That's perfectly fine.
I would describe it as a noise, as a terrible crash. Poor Zealot. It must have felt so heavy.
Hold it!
Wait, you believe that terrible crash is connected to Acolyte Zealot's death?
Yes, the sound, no doubt, was poor Zealot's death now. Such a tragedy, for he was a fine disciple. I would ask all here to give a prayer for his departed soul.
Zazurai Matame Yoma? Oh, they're not even gonna try to put that shit in there. Okay, fine. Sure, sure.
I had high hopes for that young man's future.
That thing. Why do I feel like such a jerk for just trying to do my job right now?
Mr. Wright.
I'm gonna allow you to save first.
Do you still feel the need to question the High Priest?
His alibi is as tight as can be. This isn't going well. I better ask him about something else. I'm curious, Abbott and me. Did you stop by the Rebel Hideout after His Majesty left?
Yes. I thought it would be wise to assess the situation. But as I said before, there was nothing to see. The Hideout appeared as it always had.
And the victim's body?
It was nowhere to be found. Aglaith Vey must have already disposed of it. And anything else incriminating?
So let me get this straight. When you saw the Rebel Hideout, it looked like it does in this photo here.
Yes. I would say that is how it appeared that day.
So wait, the stone slab had been put back into place.
Mr. Wright. Is it not time to concede defeat?
No, wait. I just need a little more time.
If you insist.
Okay. So that was important. I feel like it's got to be that. Like, I feel like it's got to be that the Hideout couldn't have been like that, because you would also have known. But what is this even proving? Like, legitimately, what are we... Okay. It's got to be one of the two statements we added. We pressed on this and didn't get anything else. The Hideout is exactly the same as what he saw immediately after the incident, which we know somebody cleaned up. The photo is not going to prove anything about a haunting silence. Wait. Well, fuck, we didn't mean to press on that. Now we gotta roll through this. I have an idea, but we're gonna see if it goes anywhere. If it was a terrible crash, then how? We're gonna go with this and see what we get.
Objection!
Shit. Alright. So that's definitely not it. Something the matter. Yeah, that scream just sort of slipped out. Shit. Okay. That vote is not going to do anything for us. Let me see here. Let's see. I feel like it's got to be something about the fact that the... If it's not that... Alright, I gotta talk this one out here. Alright, so at the moment, we're trying to prove... something about, like, from what I can tell, something about the hideout. How could he even... How does the fact that the hideout looks exactly the same not line up with something he said? Could it be that he would have also heard the cleaning up as well?
Objection!
No, okay, fuck. I don't know. Yeah, that consult button can fuck right off. I'm gonna figure this out. Alright. This is the other statement he added, but I don't think we get anything out of this. That's not it. The crime occurred. Listen to a tape of the man world.
Hold it.
Basically, it's like, hey, you're fucking up too much. Here, have a hint. I believe that terrible crash is connected to Acolyte Zealot's death. Yeah, okay. There's been changes to both in testimony and evidence.
So the change is that the rebel that he saw that it was at, that this is the that this layout is the exact same layout that he that what it was when he went and checked on it after the fact. That's the change in what we know. Do we have anything else that, Wait a minute. This?
Objection!
Nope. I was like, but he didn't die by that, but he wouldn't know that. Fuck. Get to roll through this. Yes, yes, I'm guilty. Jesus, fuck. It's not the first time I've done this. Yada, yada, yada. We've heard this one, like, three or four times this case, because this case has been, I don't know, like, this case is just getting weird on me, and I don't quite understand, like, I'm lost in the logic that I'm trying to disprove, and I don't know where to go. Do I have to re-get all of the testimony parts, or does he still have, or do I still have them? Get your consult shit out of my face.
Hold it!
So it goes back to the last major checkpoint. Alright, we're gonna get these two things in, which means we press...
Hold it!
This one. So he adds those two, and then we press both of those. Oops, not... Press. Not present,
Hold
press.
It.
I'm still thinking that it's the fact that he was, that it, that he thinks that it was the heavy, like. Wait, let me check something. Do I have the updated evidence? I don't. How do I get that? I don't remember how I got that. I have to have that updated evidence.
Hold it.
Oh wait, no, I'm already okay. I think I have to press everything, and then the evidence gets updated. We need that evidence updated for what I'm assuming is going to be later on. Alright, we're gonna skip through because we've already done all this once. So I wanna get to the point where we prove.
Yeah. So now we have that. I might save here. All right. That is definitely a reason why I should be going to the saves instead of going to the other things. I have an idea. I might just have presented the wrong thing. I need to see something.
Hold it!
What does he say again with this? Let me read this again. The crash is connected to the Zealot's death. The sound, no doubt, was his death now. This doesn't make me believe that it's that. It doesn't really prove anything inconsistent. Fuck. I am starting to lose it here. All right. So, right now. He heard the loud noise, and then nothing. And we literally have nothing to prove that she could have been in the kitchen. Or nothing to say that she couldn't be in the kitchen. So at the moment, like I said, right now, we're trying to prove something is inconsistent with his testimony. The new piece of evidence that we got, or the new update to the evidence that we got, is that the room in the photo was the exact same way that it looked when he came to see it, supposedly after the abbot's death. And I don't know exactly how much else we have in terms of what else to do on this. Like, to me, this is suspicious. Considering that she was never seen the entire time makes me really question it, but I don't have anything to go off of that. Did we try pressing this to the...
Objection!
We did. All right. Fuck. We've already pressed the evidence that I would think at the back would be useful. Let me go over all of our evidence again. Alright, a figure cure, purification right, thick white ice. Could we start trying to go after this one? Maybe. But how does this disprove that she, like, how would this disprove the statement? I'm actually losing it here. Like, my brain is just not putting the buttons together for the way they need me to put the buttons together, which is really annoying. Super, super fucking frustrating. I'm about to just start pressing with, like, this to everything, which is, again, dumbass fucking way to do it. But at the moment, I'm just like, what the fuck are we even doing here? We're gonna be dumb, because I don't know the answer to this one. Burda, 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 burda. I don't want to hit this button, but I feel like I have to, because otherwise we're just gonna be sitting here for a while. So what the fuck does this button even do? I can't find any inconsistencies there. Have you ever looked something important? The one statement doesn't seem right, but I can't put my finger on it. I better look at the evidence again, too. Wait, we fucking... This is the one that they're like... Are they fucking highlighting the evidence? Wait, whoa, what? Hold everything. By the way, Lee, yes, that is somebody, that is a naked guy with Maya's hair, because Maya is currently channeling the spirit of the high priest. By the way, I swear to fuck I presented that statement, to that thing, to that piece of evidence of that statement already. But yeah, Maya is currently channeling the high priest, And you know what happens whenever you channel somebody in this game? You go, and you get her hair. You keep the hair and you keep the clothes, but the body physically changes. So it's the high priest's body, but with Maya's hair and Maya's clothing. And when he came back, he's like, wow, this fucking kimono is like stiff as fuck. I can't really move it. And he undid himself. I swear to God, I presented that piece of evidence to this thing, but I must have, I don't know, maybe I did it before the, I don't know how that didn't happen, but sure. This was something I thought originally, but fuck, whatever. Evan and me, you said, and I'm going to quote here, poor Zealot, it must have felt so heavy. Why do you think he felt something heavy? You said the hideout... Okay, yeah, that actually does make sense for the logic to go with. You said that the hideout looked like it did in this photo. If so, there's nothing that would lead you to believe he had experienced a heavy feeling. That's a really good point, and I don't know how I didn't go with that, but yeah. Alright. The fact is, of course... A stone slab did fall over on Acolyte Zealot, impaling him on the Warbad statue behind him. But that was only revealed through her benevolence's divination seance earlier.
Would the defense please get to the point?
My point is, simply hearing a crashing sound shouldn't have automatically led him to conclude that the victim was crushed to death.
I still don't see your point.
I'm saying that the High Priest knew. God, that's a horrible way to go. He knew how the victim was really killed.
Why?
And that is information only the real killer could have known.
I definitely saw it that time.
I mean, I could think of a way he would know that even if he wasn't there, but... That's gonna bring up some really weird implications, but either way. How do you mean? Like, how's it gonna be strange there? And and watch the live? Like, how do you mean? Is there something strange going on? Oh, shit, you guys are... springing forward. I actually didn't know Brazil did that. I thought that was more of an American tradition. Doing daylight savings time bullshit. But yeah. I mean, technically that puts you online in time with us. But that is kind of a weird... I hate springing forward. I love falling back. And it's a simple thing of like, when you spring forward, you lose an hour. And when you fall back, you gain an hour. So, yeah. It's weird. But like I said, I had no idea Brazil did that.
I definitely saw it that time.
I've got the High Priest spirit shaking in his boots. Or should I say, sandals?
Need I remind you that Abbot Inmi was with his magistry at the time of the crime? Such an alibi precludes him from being the killer.
Well, that actually is true. So he actually can't be the killer. However, he knew how Zealot was killed. Something only the killer could know. Can this discrepancy be resolved somehow?
Well, Mr. Wright, we're waiting for an explanation.
I was just getting to that. I gotta think of something real quick. The High Priest knew something only the killer could have known because he heard it from the real culprit. He must have heard how the victim died from, the real killer? Yeah, the real killer!
The real killer?
Of course, that makes perfect sense. I don't want to believe it, but this is the only possible explanation. So tell us, who is the real killer?
Oh, baby.
It's gotta be someone close to the real killer, someone without an alibi. I have been thinking this for a while, and we finally get to get it. Get that widow in here!
Your Majesty, while you were visiting the High Priest's home, you didn't see Miss Inmi at all, did you?
No. I never saw her, but... What does that have to do with anything?
I mean, for springing forward, I'm not sure how that would actually work. I mean, I guess that means you have the lights on less because there's more daylight. But, like, that's the only thing I could think of with that, is that that's like the only way I could think of that you would use less electricity in that case. Did the High Priest ever leave your sight?
No. We were talking the entire time. And the food was brought right to the room in the room's entry.
Really? The entryway? So the High Priest has an ironclad alibi. But his wife doesn't.
What in the devil are you insinuating?
I'm insinuating that Miss Inmi might have killed Acolyte Zealot. You can believe it, motherfucker.
You have a lot of nerve making such a baseless allegation. She had no motive to kill Acolyte Zealot. He was like family to her.
Bitch, you could say that for my client. No, you don't get to get away with saying that as a valid reason why someone couldn't have killed someone. Nope. We can't entirely discount the idea. Especially if you consider that Ms. Enmi could have been the one posing as Lady Kira.
Ooh, we're going for both. We're going for a fucking double hitter. Just a 1-2 punch of get fucked.
Even a fool must temper his foolishness at times. Or do you truly believe Lady Kira would kill Acolyte Zealot, though he was not a rebel?
Objection!
As we all know, the High Priest was secretly a rebel. It would follow that his favorite disciple could very well be a rebel too.
Are you suggesting that Miss Inmi killed her husband as well?
Yeah, it's as sad as it is to think that she killed her own husband to rid the kingdom of rebels. I don't think we can rule it out. Ooh, he doesn't like the fact that we're going after Wifey Poo.
Good.
You claim my wife is the rebel hunting Lady Kira? And that she slew both Zealot and myself? My lovely wife? That is utterly impossible!
That is some fucking commanding presence there. That's fucking... Oh, well, you know what? That actually explains where Cords of Steel came from. Now that I think about it.
I have never seen the High Priest so angry.
It is as Abbot Inmi stated. And the accused has already been found guilty of his murder. It is far too late to overturn it.
That's right, Mr. Wright. Now apologize to the good priest before he gets angry again. Quickly now! It's the end of the year, so many people normally stay all the night. Yeah, see, exactly. See, I had it right. I at least had the right idea, sort of. Thank you for confirming that.
No, I'm not going to apologize. The true identity of Lady Kira is a major piece to this trial's puzzle.
Admit it, Abbot Inmi. Your wife, Lady Inmi, killed you. Yet even now, you continue to lie in an effort to protect her.
How absurd. It appears the lawyer has forgotten. My lovely wife could not possibly battle the rebels in the guise of Lady Kira. We were blessed by Her Holiness, and she is with child.
Praise be to the Holy Mother.
That's easy enough to fake. Like, legitimately, that's easy enough to fake. Or, you know, she could... I don't see how fucking being pregnant prevents her from doing the shit that she did. So, yeah. Let's go with that. You forgot about that.
That abominable lady Garavigor who slew me and Acolyte Zealot was the accused.
This is bad, but I can't give up now.
Don't forget, my client doesn't have the strength to fight rebels either.
How could a weak young woman like her possibly... Are you going to explain this? I would love to know how you would explain this. She doesn't seem like... She seems like she's in an early enough stage of pregnancy. Like, she wasn't showing at all. Like, if she's not showing at all...
I mean, admittedly, I'll be the first person to admit I know literally nothing about how pregnancy affects a woman's body. I got nothing but, like, fourth-hand rumors about how that shit happens and what happens there. But if she's not showing, in my eyes, that's not necessarily going to preclude her from doing super amounts of things. And it's never been stated how far along in the pregnancy she is. But still, let's see how you're going to get around this.
You foolish oaf of a lawyer. If only you were as blessed as Lady Inmi.
Wait, what? Surely.
Surely, the accused possesses the strength, or should I say, the power. The power to battle those black-hearted rebels.
Are you literally going to use the fact that she can channel energy to do that?
What are you talking about?
My good prosecutor, I see you have come to the same conclusion as I. Such keen insight. Then you have figured it out as well, Abbot Inmi. May I ask you to explain to this putrid-brained lawyer?
God, he absolutely loves that word. Goddamn.
Certainly, for I cannot allow him to frame my lovely wife for murder.
Foreign devil!
Your Majesty, allow me to testify as to how Maya Fey is that murderous Lady Kira.
Well, if it were to assuage your anger, then by all means, please testify.
Good. Good. We're gonna get to shoot this shit down.
Acolyte Fey channeled Lady Kira's spirit. She is a spirit medium who knows Lady Kira's true name, so she could have done it.
This was ever said, but I think there was something in the guise of knowing how spirit channeling works that requires you to know what their fucking face looks like. Well, okay, he may know, like, he probably knew about the tome because his fucking wife was the person who does it, who was supposed to do it. She would have had the tome a little bit before Maya got a hold of it.
She is a spirit medium who knows Lady Kira's true name, so she could have done it. So it was really Lady Kira who returned to root out the rebels among us. She attacked and killed me with the strength of far beyond any mortal woman.
Let's see. Yeah, but at 3 months... Okay. I would assume that at 3 months, you would be showing slightly. Maybe. I don't know. I'm probably completely wrong about that one, but sure, whatever. Now, admittedly, at this point, we actually don't know how far along in her pregnancy she is. It's never really been said. But...
Do you understand now? Murder by spirit channeling explains everything.
Not really. Nope.
This is the only way the accused could have defeated one rebel after another.
Indeed. I am a living, or shall I say dead, proof of her terrible power.
Maya's ability to channel spirits? It's come back to haunt her? Well, that's not the first fucking time.
Now, is it not time to let it go and move on, defense?
Bullshit! I'm gonna punch you in your dick. I'm gonna punch you in your dick with evidence. Because we're gonna find a contradiction in the things that you said, because you said them. No, never. I'll never give up. Now what? Think. How can I prove that Maya couldn't have channeled Lady Kira? Like I said, fuck if I understand anything about what happens to a woman's body during pregnancy in terms of what they are and aren't capable of. That is beyond my capability of understanding at this point in my life. So just nope, just not even gonna deal with it. It's just a thing that happens. Sure. I'm gonna save here just so we have a point to start with. He is a very self-deprecating individual. He's like,
I gotta guess, it's this?
And then it just sort of ends up being right. I mean, we can see from the outside that it's right because we see a lot of putting pieces together. And he's a lawyer and he's smart, it's just... He's had shit that, like, his shit seems to be roller coaster ride, up and down of, I got it, no, I don't got it, oh, I got it, oh, I got it, no, I don't got it, until the ride ends and he has it. But he doesn't always know that the ride's not going to crash from underneath him.
Hold it!
Alright. My client, Channel Lady Kira, isn't that a little far-fetched?
Far-fetched, you say? Why, the very fact that I am here proves that she has the power to channel spirits.
But you know proof she actually channeled Lady Kira.
Oh, but I do.
Wait, you... Oh, well, hang on. Alright, let me see this real quick. Alright, I want to see what he says. I was really fucking surprised to see him. I thought we were going to get a third, pain relative that was also a lawyer in a fucking foreign country. We just happened to be meeting and just happened to be like, I guess we'll defend you. Like, that was strange. It was very strange. Well, it's true she may be capable of channeling Lady Kira. I don't have any proof that she did.
We are talking about the infamous Rebel Hunter here. That modern-day Lady Kira has captured many a rebel all by herself. And among them have been more than a few great warriors. Who but the real Lady Kira could have accomplished such a feat?
It would be difficult for a mere mortal. That leaves the real Lady Kira of legend as the only likely answer.
Indeed. Is it not proof that the real Lady Kira of legend had been channeled?
The real Lady Kira of legend? That's an oxymoron if I've ever heard of one. Then again, the people of Crane believe the legends to be true.
Hold it!
Excuse me. Wait, did that actually happen at the end of Dual Destinies? I don't actually remember him getting fired at the end of Dual Destinies. Are you kidding me? I mean, he does tend to fuck up a lot. And he's not really the best prosecutor, so... I mean, I can understand it. It's just... I don't remember that happening. I may have to go back and double check what happened in Dual Destinies. Is Lady Kira an actual person?
Do you really believe there was ever a woman that powerful? One capable of battling rebels much bigger and stronger than herself?
There is no way to prove that. But to doubt the existence of Lady Kira is to doubt the Kuranism itself. It is not for us to question. We must simply believe.
Yeah, how dare you doubt our legends? You'll regret saying that, you Paul Kukan. Lady Kira's gonna strike your ass down.
I won't get anywhere until I can refute their claims with some evidence.
Hold it!
Alright, let's see what he says here. A strength far beyond any mortal woman. And just how strong would that be?
You need but look at the wound she inflicted upon my body. Though I had hoped to never think of that about that again.
Your wound? God damn, they need to do that. Like, I can probably get a copy of Ace Attorney Investigations 1, and I can probably find a way to play Ace Attorney Investigations 2 with an English patch. So that'll probably happen at some point on this stream. Maybe not right away, but let's see. Excuse me. It's pretty deep, and there's a tremendous amount of blood.
And while Acolyte Zealot was rather small in stature, he was strong. Nevertheless, he was no match for the sheer strength of Lady Kira.
My spirit channeling is proof that she's Lady Kira? This is not good.
Oh yeah, that's right. I do remember that scene, Lee. I forgot about that.
That's good memory, man. I have to prove that she didn't channel the original Lady Kira. I have an idea. So we don't have anything to prove how spirit channeling works. So it has to be that she did strength, that it was a strength thing. I mean, the argument that, like, there's no way to fucking prove this. Think of right now. Well, yeah, I'm pretty sure it has to do with the fact that she has to know both her name and has to know her true face, and no one's ever seen her true face before. And, like, this thing has a picture of her, but it doesn't show her true face. It shows the mask.
I'm gonna try this. Let's start here.
Objection!
Oh, I was right. I like when I'm right. The Tome of Secrets is only given to the priestess who performs the purification rite. Is this your proof that my client could have channeled Lady Kira? Oh, wait a fucking second! Oh, God! I didn't even think about that! Okay, so I understand the logic behind this one now. Remember, when was Maya chosen to be Lady Kira? It was very recently. How the fuck could she have been Lady Kira for the past 2 fucking years if she didn't have that book until just recently? I hadn't even thought about that line of questioning, but yeah, that's gotta be where we're going here. Let's go.
Yes, indeed. For it contains the true name of Lady Kira, a secret only revealed within.
Have it in me. I'm afraid you're mistaken. This couldn't have been used to channel Lady Kira. Well, okay, maybe they're going with the first one.
Mr. Wright, would you care to explain?
This is why my client couldn't have channeled Lady Kira. Oh, baby, we're already going for it. I have the right idea.
Take that!
Lady Kira's face is hidden behind a mask in the Tome of Secrets. You need both a name and a face to channel a spirit.
It can't be!
Wait, okay, hang on. When his spirit leaves the body, is that Maya's body that is just topless behind the thing? Sure, whatever. Alright, sure. Without a face, it would have been impossible for my client to channel Lady Kira.
Oh, my. That's a good point.
Therefore, the claim that she became Lady Kira by means of spirit channeling is patently false. And with Lady Kira out of the equation, my client had no motive to commit murder.
But then, who is the rebel hunting Lady Kira we've been reading about in the paper?
Yes. Oh, excuse me.
Yes. Who is this other suspect? If indeed there is one at all. Let us hear the defense's brilliant deduction.
So, if we go by the idea of knowing who Lady Kira is, it would have to be the High Priest, or the High Priest's wife. Miss Inu was suspicious, but her pregnancy takes her out of the running, and Miss Arbal is a Mr. Rebel is a rebel. That doesn't make any sense. That is just with. Oh God. Please tell me we're not about to suspect the Queen. Oh God, no, please don't do this to me.
Mr. Wright, you have that look again. The one where you know you have to say something, but you can't figure out what it is.
This is my chance to really turn out to you. I'll just have to stir the pot until something floats to the top. Your Majesty, I know who's been posing as the rebel hunting Lady Kira.
You do? Are you sure about that?
Yes, completely.
I sense that I may regret this, but please go on and explain.
Thank you, Your Majesty. This is who's been posing as the rebel hunter, Lady Kira. Are we about to do this? But then it doesn't explain. Oh my God.
Zealot was the one I was thinking of, but then that doesn't explain who the fuck killed the High Priest. That doesn't explain who killed the High Priest at all. We're only proving who's the Rebel Hunter. Yeah, it's a little weirdly. He's like, oh, hey, wait a minute. I was in there for a second. Hang on. And just sort of dives back down. Let me read this real quick. It couldn't have been him, because he's been in prison. She doesn't have the spirit energy to channel. It clearly is not going to be this motherfucker. It wouldn't have been him, because he was a rebel. She hasn't been in the country long enough. It doesn't make fucking sense for Maya to be it. You know what? This is the if they're saying that her pregnancy rules her out, this is the only thing that makes sense to me. But it doesn't make sense. But we're going with it, so take that!
Take that!
True identity of the rebel hunting lady Kira we seek is praise a lot.
Well, what's this? The high priest murdered disciple was Lady Kira, you say?
Ooh, I think we might have did we get this right?
Peace! I say peace!
Judge... like... I mean, again, this country's really weird against defense lawyers, so if he heard one of his, like, distant relatives was fighting with us, then I sure, yeah. Just roll with it.
The defense will continue!
Yes, Your Majesty. I would have done the list of suspects until there was only one left.
But a process of elimination is not the same as solid evidence. I assume you have evidence to back up your claim?
Yes, of course I do. I will have some in a moment, that is, at least I hope so. Maya wasn't Lady Kira, and neither was Miss Enmi or any of the other possibilities. That leaves Zealot, and I have the evidence to prove it. I do? Really? I have the evidence to prove this? Really, Phoenix? Okay. The evidence that proves Acolyte Zealot was posing Lady Kira is this. Fucking what? I hadn't thought about... Well, it would be a really good plot twist to find out there's just been some fucking conspiracy against Phoenix for a long time. And then it's just now coming up and the judges wanted revenge. That would be a...
That'd be a weird twist, but sure, I could go with it.
Take that!
It has to be this. This is what proves that Acolyte Zealot was Lady Kira. The warning letter.
How absurd. What could that possibly prove?
Prosecutor Saad Mahdi, you stated this was a warning letter that proved that my client was Lady Kira. And the reason you gave was that the High Priest's house was locked tight. But there was another member of the family who lived there. Therefore, Acolyte Zealot could have delivered the warning anytime he wanted. What is he talking about? That's just not possible. Why are you suddenly shifty?
Are you saying Lady Kira was not the culprit, but rather the victim?
That's exactly what I'm saying.
But that would... That would overturn the entire premise of this case! This trial has proceeded on the assumption that Lady Kira was behind the serial killings. But if Lady Kira is one of the victims, who was the killer, and what was their motive?
The only suspect left is Miss Inmi. And there's only one possible motive. Oh god, are you saying... Wait. Are you saying that she figured out who Lady Kira was? And then discerned that I'm going to have to kill him so he doesn't kill my fucking husband? Oh, that is gonna get messy. And there's only one possible motive. What if Miss Enemy's a rebel? My throat is still recovering from like all of the bullshit shenanigans of TwitchCon and the fact that like I got some sort of weird congestion bullshit. So I'm not gonna scream as loud as I possibly could, but we're gonna try something.
What?
Not a full thing, but a burst.
Dang. You're still bent on casting suspicion upon my lovely wife? Blasphemer! You have no evidence of this. Repent for the mistrust in your soul.
Well, you have no evidence either. After all, the dagger with my client's prince was... With my client's prince on it, was it what killed Acolyte Zealot? And the plumed Punisher theme that he could hear could have been an alarm clock. That means all of this evidence linking her to the crime scene has been called into question.
Was Lady Inmi a rebel, and did she pose as Lady Kira to kill Acolyte Zealot? Or was Acolyte Zealot a rebel?
And was the accused Lady Kira... Was the accused the Lady Kira who killed him? I would say either scenario is just as likely.
What are we to do now?
The alarm clock, you say? Do you mean the one in the rebel hideout?
Yeah, but what of it? So that's it. What the hell's gotten into him? I want to do Cords of Steel, but I can feel my throat dying every time I do it, like, within the past little bit. I'm still trying to recover from TwitchCon. Like, my throat has just been utter shenaniganized. It's dumb. Hey there, Silky Kittens. How you doing? How are things? Thank you for stopping in. What's gotten into him?
Abbot in me. Just what is so comical?
Forgive my outburst. That has simply tickled my funny bone.
What did?
The theme song came from the Plumed Punisher clock, you say? Hmm.
That alarm clock could not have possibly gone off.
What makes you say that? The clock was working just fine the last time I checked it.
It's possible we could see Robin. Robin would be a fun addition to Phoenix's ever-growing arsenal of young lawyers. That would be kind of a fun one. Oh, see, going AFK is a... Well, if he said he's going AFK and then just hasn't come back yet, that's not necessarily the worst. But if he didn't say anything and went AFK, that's pretty fucky. That's not cool.
Try using your head for a change. Would not the existence of a secret hideout be given away if an alarm clock kept going off?
Wait, you don't mean...
Indeed. We leave the alarm switched off at all times.
Ooh.
In that case...
I am sad to say, but the defense's claim does not hold water.
Would you care to respond, Mr. Wright?
Oh. This can't be happening. Not now. Phoenix, please. You know this happens every time.
This should put an end to the lawyer's futile struggles. The theme song the victim heard was from the accused's strap, just as we suspected.
I wonder if it's never come up to him that strap got traded really recently.
Therefore, the accused is the rebel hunting Lady Kira and the victim's killer.
I need an opening, something I can raise an objection to.
That bloomed Punisher theme song Acolyte Zealot heard in his final moments? I too heard it by way of the listening device.
But did you really? If you had heard it, why didn't you testify to that fact before?
Is it not obvious? I did not know such a tune could become a key matter of dispute.
Yes, the matter of the theme song came up before Abbott and me was channeled.
Right. Yeah, okay, Hugh, I don't know what's actually going to happen to him. I really don't, because his... I think he's smart enough to get away with it. I just don't think he's smart enough to... I think he's smart enough to get through lawyer school, or law school, or whatever you want to call it. I just don't think he's smart enough to be top of his class. And he doesn't like not being top of his class, so... I think that's Hugh's problem.
Oh, right. Well then.
What if he's lying about the clock alarm being switched off?
Miserable wretch. That would be a pointless lie, one easily disproven.
If you check the clock, you will see that the alarm is, in fact, switched off.
Come to think of it.
What a fine item in this switch, if I'm right.
Rafa would know about it. We set the switch back in the off... back into the off position before we left. Fuck us.
I remember hearing it clearly. Those distinctive taiko drum...
Oh, fuck. Really? I'm pretty sure taiko drums aren't distinctly Koreanese. Ooh, that's an important fact. Oh, fuck.
Though distinctive taiko drums in the intro are etched into my mind, they went...
We need a lot more Daka for this one. Daka, don, don, don. Don, 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 don. Distinctive taiko drums in the intro?
This trial has gone on too long. Far too long. Shall we move ahead to the verdict phase now?
By all means. And let us also return Abbot Envy's spirit to the Twilight Realm.
Before I go, let me say a word to my darling wife.
No.
Wait, are you saying you don't like this game, or you don't like Dungeon of the Endless? I'm not sure which one you're talking about there.
But yeah, Lee, I believe that Hugh probably could be, like, in, like, the top five of his class, but he might actually have a hard time actually hitting being number one in the class. But that was just my impression. Dungeon of the Endless is I don't think it's nearly as fun as a single player game. You really need to be doing it. You really need to be playing it with friends in order to get away with it. Oh, ha! Explosions are assholes. We actually, I forget what the name of the turret is, but there's one defense thing you can set up that basically is just like, yeah, no, I'm going to explode. Well, but it also it damages everything in the room. That includes yourself. What we usually do is we set like a choke point, and it's like, okay, there's a slowing mechanism and then four or five or X number of exploders. And then we never went in that room. It's like, don't fight in that room ever. Never, ever, ever, ever. Yeah, like, I think it would be a good... I think it's a good place to go to if we ever need newer people that don't involve Phoenix or something for whatever fucking reason. Now, hold on just 1 minute. Your Majesty...
Yes?
The High Priest's statement is inconsistent with a certain piece of evidence.
It is?
Still, you writhe in defiance of your fate? The very sight reminds me of a tortured soul writhing in flames.
You won't be saying that once I show you the evidence. Now, all I have to do is pick the right one. This piece of evidence is inconsistent with that statement about the Taiko drum intro. Pretty sure this is... Oh, it's not. It's not what I thought it was. Everybody with me. 3, 2, 1. Take that! This is what's inconsistent with this statement. My client's plumed Punisher strap.
What does that have to do with anything?
It plays the Plumed Punisher theme song. And here it is!
The theme to the Plumed Punisher, Wario of Neo Twilight Realm.
I don't hear Taiko drums, motherfucker. I like the idea that Phoenix is just like, he's just holding it up and just letting that shit run. Wait, how did you explode it? How did you explode with the crystal in your hand at the exit? That's an odd situation to run into. I think that wouldn't be a bad line for an investigation series to go through to have, like... Fuck! Do the full trio! Do Robin, do Hugh, and do, God, why am I blanking on her name? Flower Girl. Why the fuck am I forgetting her name? Fuck me. Why the fuck am I forgetting her name? Oh my God. Okay, I'm gonna have to go look this up. Unless someone in chat says it first. Juniper, yes. Do all three of them. Do an entire investigations game where it's Hugh, Robin, and Juniper doing stuff together. Instead of it being like Edgeworth, instead of it being Edgeworth doing stuff, have the three of them doing it. That'd be a fun little side game to explore. Those were interesting enough characters that you did stuff with that you could easily do a bunch of shit together with that. It would be great. I'd love that. Are you kidding me? Oh, yeah. We usually tried to communicate about never using those, and usually if one of the, I'll give you a piece of advice on this. If you have those turrets out and you're making the run with the crystal to the end, they spawn enemies in every unlit room that isn't that's everywhere. If those things are on the path to the end, to the exit, just fucking destroy those turrets. They're not needed at that point. I mean, like I said, I legitimately think that would be an interesting game just to sort of bring those characters back. Do you see what I mean? Well, about that and about this. The music the victim heard in his final moments might not have been the Plumed Punisher theme song.
I'm afraid I'm not following you.
Judge, do you know what taiko drums are? Do we have to explain to you what taiko drums are?
What was it if not the Plumed Punisher theme?
In its final moments, Acolyte Zealot heard the Steel Samurai theme. Oh, baby! I mean, it's possible that somebody said they were going to do it and then maybe just didn't get done, or maybe you missed one, but that's the usual, like, hey, I should definitely go do this before we start the final run. There are no taiko drums in the intro of the Plumed Punisher theme, so what Acolyte Zealot actually heard in his final moments was the theme of the Steel Samurai, Warrior of Neo Old Tokyo.
Peace!
Peace! Peace, I say! Mr. Wright, what is this Steel Samurai of which you speak?
The Steel Samurai, Warrior of Neo Old Tokyo, is an action hero show from America. Because we live in Japanifornia, remember that. We live in America, out in Japanifornia, where it's California, but everything is Japanese styled. Because they started that with the original localizations, and they've surprisingly kept to it. The Plumed Punisher is a theme. The Plumed Punisher theme is a total. Excuse me, what did you say? What did you say, Phoenix? The Plumed Punisher theme is a total is very similar to it. If you didn't know about the Steel Samurai, you could easily mistake the two.
But the fact that Acolyte Zealot heard music from an American action hero show is irrefutable evidence the accused was in the secret hideout.
Ah, no, it's not. Mm-mm-mm. Actually, no. You have it backwards.
Backwards?
That's right. Miss Faye met an avid Plumed Punisher fan here in Kurain. And as a token of their friendship, she traded a certain Steel Samurai item she had for the Plumed Punisher strap. I mean, okay, we're not even talking the ridiculous. Okay, hang on. I'm gonna see if I can find this real quick. I'm gonna see if I can find a trailer for this. Or maybe a good screenshot. Specifically where they're presenting evidence. I really want to see where they're presenting evidence. Do I have a thing where they're presenting evidence? Please tell me there's a shot of them presenting evidence. Oh my god. Okay. There doesn't seem to be... Let me see if I can find this. There has to be a clip of this guy, of them presenting evidence. Because the evidence presentation is fucking amazing. Like, it's absolutely insane. They are okay. So I'm gonna demonstrate this because like you need like a physical demonstration. That's not the fucking right scene. You need a physical demonstration of this. So the live action film. If you've never seen the live action film for Phoenix Wright, I recommend you go track it down by whatever means you can. They literally have holographic projectors up there on the scene in the actual movie. And what they're doing when they're throwing evidence at each other, he's literally got the evidence piece in front of him, and he's going wham and just hitting it over to the other side. And Edgeworth is over there sitting and just stops it with one hand right in front of him. And yes, Silky Kittens, the thing you saw is new. I saw it on a stream and started did a little research to figure out where it was. Oh, well, actually, hang on. You know what? I can do this real fast. Image. Because this will give you an idea. This is actually an image from the movie. We'll put it in. Put it in here. Because I can add this as a scene, as a thing in the scene real quick. Image thing. Browse. Holy shit. Okay. All right. So take a look at this thing right here. You see this? You see how he has that giant green screen in front of him? That is the imagine that as like the holographic projection of a piece of evidence. And you can see he's sort of rearing back. He is literally about to just slam that over towards the prosecution side for them to deal with. It's an absolutely insane sort of 2-hour condensation of cases one, slightly, case two, and then like case five. Phoenix Wright games you don't have to have evidence of where you bring stuff. Of course not. Why would that ever matter in a world where evidence is really important? Come on now. It was the little screwdriver thing. There's a screwdriver, I think, that he had, that he found in the room that had the fingerprints on it. But yeah, no. Go find a way to watch the live-action Phoenix Wright movie. Make sure it's subbed, because it's not. They haven't put it in English yet. It's fucking amazing. That's all I've got to say. It's just abso-fucking-lutely amazing. It's like everything is kind of normal and kind of average until they actually start presenting evidence in case two. And that's where, oh god, it starts going for a fucking loop and just woo! And then it's just a ride from there, and it's great. You should definitely just go find it at some point tonight. Like after we're done here, go find it.
And this avid plumed Punisher fan was the one who killed Acolyte Zealot?
Yes. And that avid fan is none other than the High Priest's wife. Believe in me. Objection. Oh, he doesn't like that sentence.
Do you have evidence to back up this claim, Mr. Wright?
Oh. We have evidence. Oh, baby, I am so glad. I am so glad you asked me that, Prosecutor Sadmati, because I have just the thing for you. It's called evidence.
For as forgiving as the Holy Mother is.
I just thought about something with that animation. The animation's a little janky because it doesn't account for his hair. He just pulls it off his neck, and it just, like, magic tricks its way through his fucking hair. But whatever. I can deal with it for the fact that it's a little weird, but sure.
I doubt she would tolerate yet another dose of your baseless slander.
I suggest you prepare yourself to face Her Holiness's wrath. I don't even... You can't scare me, bitch. I got you.
Oh. I'm prepared to turn this entire case upside down, that is.
This is my last chance. I better take a deep breath and review the evidence. I have already reviewed the evidence. I've already thought about this. I'll even show you guys where we're going with this in a second.
Very well, then. Please present your evidence, if you would, defense.
The evidence that proves Miss Inmi was the one who killed Acolyte Zealot is this. Oh, baby. We're going all the way over. You know what? I'm going to pull this screen up so you guys can see where we're going here. I didn't know you could do that. I didn't know you could go... I didn't know you could press up and down to go down up and down pages. That's... How the fuck have I never known that? All right, let's take a look at this. I want you guys to pay very, very, very close attention to Miss Inmi's wrist. There's a clock on there. I'm pretty sure that's the thing that Maya traded. But let's see if we're right. Alright, everybody with me. 3, 2, 1.
Take that!
It's right here. In this family photo. Proof that Miss Inmi and Miss Faye traded items featuring their favorite characters.
A family photo? And what exactly should we be looking at here?
We got him. Well, they really started the fingerprinting shit with Case 5 in Game 1. But then they sort of went away from it after that, but that's fine. The proof that they exchanged their items featuring their favorite characters is right here. Look at Miss Inmi's left wrist. Zoom. Enhance. Oh my god, I thought that was a watch face. Holy fuck. Look at this thing. Let's go right here. Look at this thing. Look at this motherfucker right here. Oops, I'm... Okay, so don't ever have it on that screen when you're doing this. Look at this. I didn't actually notice that it's the face. I didn't notice that it was the face. It is the Steel Samurai's face. I didn't know that. I thought it was an actual watch face that just had like a little bobble thing at the top of it or something. Sure. You can see the Steel Samurai's trademark top knot right there. Which clearly makes this a Steel Samurai watch.
Why, I never knew your wife had such hobbies evident in me.
This family photo was taken right before Acolyte Zealot was murdered. By that point, my client had the plume Punisher, had the Punisher strap, and Miss Inmi had the Samurai watch. So what the victim heard in his final moments was none other than the sound of the watch Miss Inmi was wearing. I wish to amend my testimony. What I thought were taiko drums were something else. My wife never had such a watch. It is the truth, I tell you. You must believe me, Your Majesty. Oh, I think he's pissed now. I wonder what he's actually saying, because that it sounds like he's saying Japanese. It literally sounds like he's speaking Japanese right there. I think. Maybe. I don't know.
Be not deceived by the defense's lawyerly chicanery.
Now what? He's been pretty quiet up to this point. What the hell does he have up his sleeve now?
There's a big gaping hole in his flimsy claim.
A big gaping hole? No, I don't think so.
Oh, no. I'm afraid it's there, all right. Just like the big gaping hole in your putrid brain.
Good God, I want to slap the word putrid out of this motherfucker's speech. Okay, roleplay. You didn't get to see the close-up that I can see. Like, I don't know exactly of a good way to do this. Let me see here. Let me go full screen for a second. Try to move shit out of the way. I need to close that. And I need to close that because that has personal information on it. Cool. We are cool here.
and we're cool there, but we're not seeing that. All right, so what you guys can't see. Hi there. That is how big it is on my screen. So I was able to see it at a significantly higher picture rate than what you guys could see. It was significantly bigger for me than it was for you guys. So I could see that she had a watch on in that picture. And I knew that it was never said who she traded with, but like I figured out that's who she traded with from that. I just never had to bring it up. Well, I wasn't sure if it was like something like with the watch that you like touch, like you hit the top knot and it says the timeout or something like that. At this point, he might as well be using Shadow Clone Jutsu because he's got to come up with a lot of excuses real fast. I understand what it is. I understand that it's a mantra. I'm just like, what are those, like, do they just make up some gibberish that he says, or is that an actual thing? My brain is neither putrid nor full of holes. I'm not a zombie, after all.
Says the dead lawyer walking. He who is narrow of vision focuses on what is before him, never seeing the big picture.
I want to see how the fuck you're gonna disprove the evidence that we have.
Or, as they say in your country, you cannot see the forest for the trees.
I'm actually surprised he knows that phrase. Well, I guess he is the worldly traveling lawyer.
For if it is as you say, and Lady Inmi, the rebel, slew Acolyte Zealot, the rebel hunting Lady Kira, then the rebel hunter would have been dead before the high priest was slain.
Yeah, that's what we've been inferring the entire fucking time. That means the High Priestess could not have been slain by the rebel hunting Lady Kira. That is a good point. I don't know how we're gonna get around that. But that doesn't refute literally everything else we've said. That's just something else we have to understand. How the hell could I have missed that?
So tell me, who are you going to say killed the High Priest now?
No.
Do you finally understand the sheer size of the holes that riddle your putrid brain?
Okay, so what you're saying is, you're not refuting the fact that that Lady Inmi killed Zealot, but now you're just like, well, then who actually killed the other person? Sure. Okay. That probably is what it translates to. I wouldn't be surprised at that point. Knowing him, he loves it. There is probably putrid somewhere in that phrase somewhere. Just, I don't know where, but it's in there. I'm in hot water now. Again. I don't have any other suspects in the High Priest murder.
You mindless zombie. You should have begun your journey into the Twilight Realm long ago. Now let it go and move on.
Nope. I'm never gonna give it up. I just need to think things through and figure out who really killed the High Priest. Oh, here we go. Okay, so Phoenix learned how to do this from Apollo. Alright, well, there's not any point in like saving here, I don't think. Like, I don't think we can actually lose from this. This is the big, like, super revelation moment. Alright, if Acolyte Zealot had been Lady Kira, he couldn't have killed the High Priest. The question is, who did? And then get to the bottom of this by reviewing the events of the case in order. What evidence could tell me something about the crime scene before the dagger? Wait. It had to be... Yeah, all right, it has to be the testimony. Oh shit, I'm going way too fast. The spring was red before we got in there. Oh, okay. All right. Maya said that the spring had been stained red before the rite even began. The spring was already red for the High Priest murder because of... It's got to be because of Zealot's blood, right?
Jesus!
spring was stained red by his blood. Fuck.
That's right. Zealot had been killed in the rebel hideout the day before the rite, and his blood flowed into the spring. Wait a second, the high priest knew that the Zealot had been killed in the hideout. So why didn't he report it to the authorities? If Maya had been the killer, he could have easily arrested her on the spot. Why didn't the high priest inform the authorities right then? He wanted to keep the hideout hidden?
Oh god! I'm never gonna get used to this! Shit!
Ugh! If he reported Zealot's murder, the authorities would find out about the hideout. That's what he was worried about. They would know he was a rebel at that point.
Yeah, but, like, review scores... Fuck review scores.
I mean, a 7 is still a good game. It's just, like, not a must play. If you don't... A 7 to me is... Or a 7.5, it to me is, hey, if you like these kind of games, you're gonna like this game. If you've never seen this game before, you might like it. But maybe not. Also, it doesn't help that I don't trust IGN. Like, I haven't trusted IGN scores in a really long time. Wait. Whoa. Bullshit. Hang on. IGN, I know you're in chat, and I know you're listening to me, and I know that you value my opinion. But if you want puzzles like Professor Layton versus Phoenix Wright, go play Professor Layton games. Did you never play a Phoenix Wright game before that one? Like, seriously, fuck off. That's not a valid reason at all for giving it a 5.5. But by going through with the rite, the High Priest risked having Maya see the spring running red with blood. Why did he have to go through with the rite? He wanted to kill Maya. He had to set up the scene during it?
Jesus! Why am I never gonna get used to this? Fuck! Ugh!
He wanted to set up the crime scene to conceal the hideout. But how was he planning on concealing the source of the blood in the spring? Wait, what? Oh my god, did he kill himself? Oh, this is gonna get really weird really fast. He wasn't gonna empty the spring. He wasn't gonna use Maya's blood because he wasn't gonna kill Maya.
Fuck. God. Ugh.
Shit. He concealed the source of the blood with his own blood. That's how he kept the rebel hideout a secret. It's all starting to fall into place. But like I said, at that point, that means he killed himself. I knew who killed the high priest. Killed himself. That is something I hadn't thought about at all. Holy fuck. Whoa. Okay, hang on. I can't believe it. The high priest took his own life to keep the rebel hideout a secret. Shit. What the fuck? The high priest wasn't murdered by anyone. He took his own life to keep the rebel hideout a secret.
Whoa. Whoa. Whoa.
What's this?
I was like, it's either the queen or his wife trying to keep shit secret.
The high priest committed suicide? I have never heard of anything more absurd!
The lawyer has placed a stain on the good priest's death with his putrid brain. Its putrid gaping holes are as large as the holes in his logic.
What hole?
You still fail to understand. You truly cannot see the forest for the trees.
You keep using that word. I don't think you know what that word means. Or phrase means. Words. Yeah.
You claim the high priest took his own life. But have you considered who brought the dagger to the Plaza of Devotion? After the high priest was killed, the dagger was thrust into Acolyte Zealot's dead body. Only the accused Maya Faye could have done that.
No. In fact, that's not right at all.
It is as Prosecutor Sadmati says. Your claim is rather porous in its logic, and your evidence is too weak. You cannot prove the High Priest took his own life to conceal the rebel hideout.
You're right. The dagger was impaled in Zealot's body, but his body had been placed in the plaza the previous day.
Well, Mr. Wright, would you care to respond?
Zealot's body was already in the plaza the day before the raid. But what if the dagger was already in him at that time?
The scarf?
Hang on. Where was it? His scarf is kind of lackadaisically, like, just sort of there. And then if we look at this, his scarf is tight on him. Ooh, baby! We got there. What if the dagger was already in him at that time? The dagger was never at the Inner Sanctum.
What?
It's gotta be that, right? Of course. No, that... There's no need to move the dagger. It had already been stabbed into Acolyte Zealot's body the day before the rite.
What? So that means... Wait, what does that mean?
It means the dagger wasn't the weapon that took the High Priest's life. But no weapon was ever found at the Inner Sanctum. Oh, excuse me. I'm not doing the right voice.
But no weapon was ever found at the Inner Sanctum.
Well, wait. Thinking about it, there was no weapon that was actually involved in killing Abbot Zealot. So why would there have to be a weapon that killed Abbot Inmi?
If you will not listen to reason, then I insist you prove your assertion. Show us what you believe the real murder weapon to be. Oh, baby. I'm already thinking about it.
The real murder weapon? Got nothing. But I know there had to be a weapon there. I think back on the trial thus far, I could spot the clue that I needed. The hell was that noise?
Hold on one second.
What the fuck was that? Yeah, everything seems to be fine. I mean, there doesn't seem to be anything out of place. There doesn't seem to be anything wrong. That, to me, in my ears, that sounded like my roommate, who I know for a fact is not here right now. That sounded like him, like, yelping, like, or something loud. It could have been my roommate, who, I don't know, doing something, but it was loud enough that I was like, what the fuck?
Well, would the defense care to tell us what the real murder weapon is?
This is what really killed him. Okay. So that's the Warbat statue. Do we have a shot of it? I guess it'd be on. It's gotta be the statue. What really killed him has been in the inner sanctum the entire time. I know my door didn't move because I can see it over here. And I moved my door, so. So, I don't know. And its lethality has already been demonstrated by the late Acolyte Zealot. Okay, OBS, don't spike up like that. Not now. That's right. It was the Warbad statue. Oh, fuck! And he's down!
You believe that the statue claimed both victims' lives?
Would you care to chime in, Abbot Inmi? No. He lies. Pay him no heed.
Why, it's...
It's Lady Inmi. Oh, fuck. Lady Inmi. Darling, do you think this has gone on long enough? Don't you think this has gone on long enough?
Believe. Believe. No. Your Majesty, my wife knows nothing. Whoa!
Whoa, whoa, that's a little aggressive.
Please, Abbot Inmi, let your wife speak. Now, Lady Inmi, please continue if you would.
It's that time again. And what time would that be? 2:30 in the afternoon, the time my husband conducts his daily prayers, and the time Paray was slain.
Zentaiko drums kicking in! That sound, it's...
The Steel Samurai alarm. I, too, like to pray at the same time as my dear husband. So I set an alarm to remind me each day. But I had no idea it would come to this.
No, stop! She knows not of what she speaks.
Your Majesty, I am the one who slew Acolyte Zealot. A good way to make that noise.
Abbot Inmi! Bailiff! Summon a physician at once! That dead motherfucker just collapsed! The physician is now attending to the High Priest, so there is no need to fear. Now, let us continue.
Wait, what? And what about the half of him called Maya that's still amongst the living? Is in me. Will you tell us everything you know? The truth is, I am a rebel, just like my husband. This tragedy unfolded before the rite, during the Feast of Blessings. I had gone to the rebel hideout to prepare it for Dats's escape. Oh, so they were gonna shove him in there during the ceremony. Okay, at least I think that's where we're going, right? And that's when Acolyte Zealot suddenly appeared. Yes. Prey was shocked when he saw me there.
Acolyte Zealot did not know you were a rebel?
I do not believe he did. I believe he was there simply to investigate the hideout.
And then he suddenly came face to face with Mrs. Inmi.
So the true identity of the rebel hunting Lady Kira was Prey Zealot. Yes, he was a member of the secret police, serving directly under the Minister of Justice.
Secret police? Oh shit. We're going deep here.
And this is what he said to me. I can kill rebels with impunity. The Justice Minister has my back. He was using his position within the secret police to deal us rebels a heavy blow.
But murder sanctioned by the crown is still murder.
Heh. Even without the DC Act, Dirk and his insurgent scum buddies' days are numbered.
What's that supposed to mean?
Let's just say I got a little trick up my sleeve, so I'd watch it if I were you. Cause you got a defiant attitude, like one of them dragon dupes.
The trick up the minister Mr. Inga's sleeve was Lady Kira?
No, this can't be. My father would never.
This is gonna really fuck her over pretty hard. It's supposed to be a bolt out of the blue for Rafa. This explains why Acolyte Zealot abandoned his real name.
Yes. He even went as far as covering up the tattoo that all Karina's clergy members receive.
Lady Kira was a member of the secret police? That explains why no order was given to investigate her attacks.
I guess I'm not alone in hearing this for the first time.
But this cannot be!
Is this true? The Justice Minister is sanctioning state-sponsored murder? Peace! Now, Lady and me, please continue.
Perret suddenly lunged at me. That's when I pushed the stone slab towards him with all my might. But I never meant for what happened next to occur.
Okay, who's jumping in now?
Allow me to take it from here.
Abbott, in me! Are you sure you're all right now? Yeah, this went from bad... This went from... Well, I can't think of a reason why they would be doing this to... Wow, shit is real fucked real fast.
I am sorry you had to see that. But you need not worry about me. I am already dead.
Please, we need to know what was so important that you would take your own life.
After I learned that my wife had accidentally slain Zealot, I chilled his body with snow to make it seem as if he had died more recently than he had. Then, I later moved it to the Plaza of Devotion and inserted the dagger into his wound. The plaza was empty at that time, for it was before prayer time had started. Finally, I placed his body in the prayer pose, knowing that no one would notice anything was wrong until the rite had concluded.
It is perfectly plausible that no one would disturb him, even if he seemed to be praying. We do treasure our prayer time, after all.
So, you admit you tried to pin this crime on Maya Fey?
Yes, this was all my doing. I never told my wife of my plan, for surely she would have tried to stop me.
Wow, okay. I'm not gonna lie, I feel a little bit bad about this because I had her as a much more of a bitch than she actually is turning out to be. Like, whoa there. That is... I had her character pinned as a very different way. And not this way. How did you get Miss Faye's fingerprints on the dagger?
I had her hold it while we were reversing the rite the day before. And right before the rite, I drugged her with a sleeping agent. Then, I put Lady Kira's robes over the Warbat statue.
Oh, because he knows about how, he knows about how they do spirit chant, how they do, like, the seances. So, he knew he had to make it look like something else was going on at the end of his life. If it just showed him going against the Warbat statue, he knew this wouldn't never fly, but...
Clever motherfucker.
That means Maya was probably already groggy by the time the rite started.
Finally, I ended my own life to ensure that the crime would appear to have been by Acolyte Faye's own hand.
But when your body was discovered, Lady Kira's robes were on the ground. How do they end up there if they were on the statue?
After I impaled myself on the statue's dagger-like feathers, I used the last ounce of my strength to hurl my body backwards. As I did, I grabbed onto the robes, taking them with me as I fell back onto the ground.
How terrible! What possessed you to do such a thing?
You needn't have commit suicide. You needn't have committed suicide simply to frame the accused.
Prosecutor Sanmadi,
as one well-versed in our kingdom's legal system, I would expect you of all people to understand.
Understand what?
I believe he came here to, like, I guess tour the country before Maya got there. Like, I thought that was the entire purpose. Is like, I want to see this country and just kind of explore because I've never been here before. 2 weeks before Maya got there, and 2 weeks is plenty of time to do a bunch of exploring, I think. Yeah, so what we saw was not... That's why the movement looked really weird. Is because it's not somebody running at him. It's him running at something. It's the same thing we thought before with Acolyte Zealot. Where we thought that somebody was pushing him into it, but it's actually the thing falling on top of him. Alright, let me see here. Boot do do boot do do boot do 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 boot do 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 boot do do do. I'll look at this later. I don't even know if I saw that. I don't think I actually saw that scene. Like, looking at it, like, sort of skimming through it real fast, I don't think I ever saw that. Because I didn't look at too much stuff for Phoenix, right? Like, I didn't even play the demo case. So. Oh, okay. Well, that makes sense, Venomous Lawyer. I probably would have gotten that if I'd actually watched the video, but whatever. By the way, how you doing? How are things? This kingdom's legal system, Miss Enmi's crime, your suicide. It can't be. That would be sadder than sad.
Why? I believe the defense knows of what the High Priest speaks. And that's a perfect excuse to save when he's trying to do this.
Oh, they were in the middle of a call when some shit went down? Wait. Is this where the thing happened with the one trailer? Where, like... It sounded like Maya was screaming. Like, Maya was screaming because somebody, like, got hit in the head or something like that? Or hit with a rock or something? I'll go watch that video. I still have it pulled up over here. I'll go watch that video after the stream is done tonight. Yes, I finally understand. This explains why the High Priest took his own life. You... What? Is this my badge? Oh, wait, hang on. We've never... It's gotta be this, right? The Defense Culpability Act. Circumstantial evidence supports Miss Enmi's killing of Acolyte Zealot in self-defense. However, it would be next to impossible to prove it without a lawyer. That's why the High Priest wanted to pin the crime on Maya Fey.
I fail to see what that has to do with this suicide.
In Karain, the divination seance is the most important piece of trial evidence. The High Priest wanted to frame Miss Fey as a serial killer. It was a clever plan in which he made sure he'd see Lady Kira in his final moments.
The lawyer speaks the truth. That is why I placed Lady Kira's robes upon the Warbat statue. I made it seem that Acolyte Fey was the rebel hunting Lady Kira.
But... Are you saying you used my divination seance to produce false evidence? Oh, there's that thing all over again. At least the first 2 minutes here is because a really good... Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, they've always done that. Like, you can even see, it's the same animation style that you see in, like, the cutscenes that happen before the case. And they're really good at what they're doing. That's the Studio Trigger. Is that Shaft? I think it's Shaft that does the anime cutscenes. And they're really good at their animation style. They're really good at it. Like, Shaft is an amazing anime studio in terms of, like, the quality of their animation, which is probably part of the reason they use them.
Forgive me your benevolence, but it was the only way to help my lovely wife.
If you had approached me first, I could have proved that murder was in self-defense.
Perhaps. But I had little faith in lawyers, despite being a rebel.
How utterly foolish to cast away one's life for such a reason. There must have been other ways to cover up the crime.
Yet, I had done so. My wife would rush to my defense. And when the case went to trial, she would suffer the same fate as I under the Defense Culpability Act. I could not have lived with myself if she had been convicted because of that fiendish man.
This cannot be. All I have done under the laws of our kingdom has all been...
Poor Rafa. She's really taking this hard. Oh, okay. Maybe I'm thinking of a different anime cutscene then. I thought Shaft had done something for Ace Attorney. I don't know what it was, though. A1 doing it, they did a damn good job. I can't say I'm surprised.
Mr. Phoenix Wright, it is time to show the might of your legal prowess. You mustn't allow another innocent soul to be charged under that despicable law.
Of course.
I'll do whatever I can. What I have done to you and Acolyte Vey is unforgivable. I can only offer my most humble of apologies. Your Majesty?
Yes?
I ask that you please look after my wife.
You have my word.
Your Benevolence, it is time that I return to the Twilight Realm.
You should really re-robe before you do that. The pachinko machine was a little weird. I mean, pachinko machines in themselves are just a little strange, but they're not... Again, it's one of those things I'll have to see it, and when I see it, I'll probably be like, oh, I see what you mean by that. That is a little weird.
The Magatama of Parting, if you please.
Very well. Your Benevolence, please allow me the honor. Yes, it would be more fitting for you to send him on his way.
Miss Inmi.
Darling, I'm so glad I was able to see you one last time. Thank you for everything.
Hey, they actually did do it. Okay, cool.
I am sorry to leave you like this, my love. But
now you can watch over me from the world beyond.
Yes, always and forever.
Come on, let these two hug it out, please. Please, can we let them hug it out at least once? Come on.
And with every breath I take, my darling, I'll be thinking of you.
Oh, so we get a full cutscene for this. Oh, fuck. Oh no, oh fuck, I just thought about the fact that we have to- Oh shit, we gotta tell Maya what happened. She's not gonna like this. Oh fuck.
Farewell, my darling trust.
G- God damn, they are tugging on the feels for this one. Maya's just like, hey guys, I'm back. Hi, what happened? The High Priest has returned to the Twilight Realm. I about called it the goddamn the fucking Shadow Realm. God damn it, Yu-Gi-Oh! Not now! Yeah, this is real feelsy. Like, there have been, like, the Barry Big Circus or whatever that was a pretty sad case. I think that's like that was the only one that really got was like, that was really in the feels before this one. Like, holy fuck. Maya. Yeah, you're not gonna have that smile on your face in a little bit. I feel great. I guess that means he didn't leave any regrets behind. Oh, but what about the trial, Nick? Yeah, it's already over. It was a real sad reality born of love and a great tragedy born of the Defense Culpability Act.
Well, I see no need to continue this trial. Does the prosecution have anything to say?
Mr. Phoenix Wright, I owe you a debt to you, one that I will pay back in court someday.
Now, to deliver today's verdict and overturn that of yesterday's trial.
Like, to me, Barry Big Top was a tragedy. It wasn't like super sad, but there was that point where you realize, oh fuck, she killed him. And like, she doesn't even realize it. That's gut-wrenching. Like, that's horrid. And you feel bad for Acro. Like, you feel horrible for him. I really need to get a copy of the first investigation game and then get a copy of the second one and play those. But, like, this is not only, it is a tragedy, but it's real fucking sad because it's like, well, if we don't do this, I know what she's going to do. She's going to try to defend me, and then she just basically gets killed as well. So I have to do it this way in order to save my wife, and even then it still doesn't fucking stop it. Because if he had trusted us, if this fucking country's, like, weird backwards-ass, like, beliefs in lawyers hadn't fucked him, this wouldn't have happened. Fuck.
With respect to all current and previous charges against them, I hereby declare the accused, Maya Faye, and her defense, Phoenix Wright, not guilty! Confetti!
Oh, wait, do they actually do confetti in this case? I forget. No, they do butterflies, I forgot. They don't do confetti here. Oh, Investigations 2's got the feels in it? Yeah, this one had like four retries in it. Four points where I just like, I don't fucking get the logic you're trying to get to me, motherfucker. Just time to either have you guys tell me what the fuck is going on, or like have me tell me, or me just figure it out eventually. Oh boy. May 12th, 4:20 p.m. Hi, Court of Karain, accused lobby. So I was thinking, Nick, the legal system here is really stacked against the defense. It's totally unfair. Yeah, it even forced the High Priest to make the ultimate sacrifice just to protect his wife. It's just so sad. Protect the status quo, or join the revolution? If the real Lady Kira were here, I wonder which side she would take. Alright, I'm gonna save, because there's always the, hey, present this piece of evidence to make this person feel better at the end of everything. I really want to hit it on this one. Your benevolence? Huh? What? I was, just wondering. Are you alright? Quiet, you. How could I possibly be alright? Yeah, she's not doing well at all.
Who do you think you are, suddenly appearing before me, trampling my insights underfoot, and plunging the Hall of Justice into utter chaos? You even desecrated my mother and father's teaching, you soulless infidel.
She's upped her vocabulary.
She normally goes to,
words that wouldn't be those words when she's, you know, fucking annoyed with us.
Whew, that was a bit more extreme than usual. What am I to do? I always believed that communing with the victim's Mitama would lead me to the absolute truth. But each time you overturn my insights, it was revealed that they serve to support false charges rather than the truth. I am left now with that heavy truth in my heart.
I'm really sorry, Rafa.
Perhaps I am not worthy of hearing the voices of the Mitama.
Oh, this is probably going to be the priest's wife.
That's where you're wrong, your benevolence.
What? Oh, wait, no, it's... Wait, what? No, whoa. Why would you have the question marks over Maya for that? No.
Maya? Was she channeling someone else? How dare you? Your role is to bring forth the voices of the Mitama into our world. If you don't do it, who will?
You know nothing, Maya Fey. The spirit channeling, not a divination seance that brought the truth to light. How dare an outsider like you employ the queen's sacred art?
But what can I do? My spiritual power doesn't even approach yours. Is it not a cruel joke? The royal priestess, bested by a lowly outsider?
Don't be so hard on yourself.
Why not? It's worth at least a laugh or two.
She's like, what? Is Maya actually exactly twice as old as Rafa? Yes, in fact, she is literally twice as old as Rafa. You shouldn't talk like that.
Huh? Listen, your benevolence. You were just fulfilling your duty, weren't you? And you're the only one capable of performing the divination seance, right? The station of royal priestess is not something to abandon lightly.
Station of royal priestess?
The people of your kingdom believe in you. But you really mean all that you... But if you really mean all that you just said, then what are they supposed to believe in?
You know not what you speak.
Actually, I kind of do. After all, I'm only here in training so I can become the master of my village back home.
A village master, you say? I didn't know.
Seems I owe you an apology.
For even today, I called you a neophyte practitioner.
It's all right, your benevolence. Thank you for finally acknowledging me. Future queen and a future village master? I guess it shouldn't be a surprise, considering they may have a common ancestor. Maya's right, your benevolence.
Barbed head?
Oh, shit. That's a little weird. Your insights were a crucial piece of evidence in this last trial. It doesn't matter if they weren't 100% accurate. You should be proud of what you did. You played an important role in assuring that justice was served. And besides, your insights aren't the problem here. It's your kingdom's legal system. Without lawyers, your insights have come to be accepted as the sole truth. And the Defense Culpability Act, which gave rise to that, is the root of it all.
But that is the dangerous thinking of a rebel.
Yeah, I kind of thought that might happen.
Your benevolence. As a crown princess, you are destined to rule this kingdom one day. That means there will be many things you alone must determine. Things like how to keep your people happy, and what is true, and what is false. And most importantly, what role you must play therein.
Excuse me. My sinuses are Again, still trying to kill me.
I wonder if I'm even up to the task.
Knowing you and your benevolence, you're more than capable. I never heard Maya talk like this before. She's really come a long way. You want to see Maya regress a little bit? Just give her a burger.
What?
What was that? Oh, shit.
It came from the hallway! Smoke! We better go check it out, hurry!
Miss Inmi?
Mr. Wright, Acolyte Faye. I'm so sorry for what transpired. You were almost sentenced to death because of me.
What in the actual fuck is about to happen? What?
I will make amends by picking up where my husband left off. I will see the revolution through, so nothing like this can ever happen again. For that is the depth of my love for my dearly departed husband.
Lady Inmi, we gotta hurry!
Voice. Is that Mr. A Rebel?
I must tell the people. They must learn that the peace we enjoy is a false one. One built on the backs of innocents charged with false crimes under that odious DC Act. We have it in our power to forge a society in which the laws judges all of us fairly.
Oh, I've heard Case 4 is kind of a short one, but that's fine. Yeah, that must be like Crane's for determination or something. That's gotta be what it is.
Hey there, BW!
I wish we had more time to talk, but...
Dirk! Everything's ready, it's go time!
Dirk?
Oh, shit! I didn't expect him to be in the hall.
Fuck. Hi. Wait, was that the rebel leader Dirk? Really? Was that him? Really?
After him! Don't let him get away!
Well, they basically planned a giant... I guess like a fake bombing thing to get her out, so... Yeah, that's where we're going here.
The power to forge a society in which the laws judges all fairly. It's the start of a legal revolution.
Oh, baby.
Revolution time.
Hey, Nick. I hate to bother you while you're lost in thought.
But I just got this great idea.
Oh, God, what is it?
The Steel Samurai versus the Rebel Dirk. I bet it'd make for another awesome TV show. And if we threw in the Plume Punisher there, in there, everyone would go nuts over it. I'll never get what she sees in those shows.
Unfortunately, Phoenix is not a Sentai man. Just not there. Of course, he's going to be vilified. They're going to vilify him if they're going against the entrenched establishment, so... We'll see how it goes. But it's good to know that no matter what happens, Maya's always going to be Maya. Oh, wow, wait a minute, hang on. They didn't do a whole, hey, present this piece of evidence to make this person feel better thing. I'm actually kind of surprised. Normally that happens at the end of every Phoenix Wright game, or case. Turnabout Storyteller. Oh boy. Alright, so here's what's going to happen. We're going to see the beginning of this. We're going to let this go. Okay, listen. Oh no.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. What time is it? It's 9, 10.
Fuck, it's a Rakugo story? God damn it. Great. Just great.
Shisho's dead? No. Do you think he did it? Oh no. If he did it, then well, what do we do?
Hey, pull yourself together.
Don't worry. I have an idea.
I think we're back in America. And it's gonna be a fucking Rakugo story. God damn it. That makes me think of that terrible fucking anime. Oh, that anime was just... I hated it. I hated that anime so much. I imagine Rakugo is not a very... That's one of those Japanese things that is just very hard to localize. It's like one man storytelling, but with like the man doing a bunch of different voices for it. But it's very weird. It brings up memories of an anime that I just didn't like, that I was apparently the only one in the anime club here locally that didn't like it. So basically, when that came up, I was playing my DS or my Vita or I was playing Hearthstone or something. Whatever it was, I was just like, I don't give a fuck about this show. So I'll occupy myself with something else until we get going. What the heck? Who brings the defendant to his own trial late? Plus, the request was so last minute, I didn't even have a chance to talk with my client.
He's late for a very important date.
Fuck. Widget, please. My name is Athena Sykes. We have never played a game from Athena's perspective before, I don't think, right? This has never happened before. Armed with analytical psychology and a full arsenal of legal know-how, I'm a fully competent defender of the Wright Anything Agency. Though I wish my client would show up already. The trial's about to start. Appears we made it just in time. Where have you been? Trial's about to start, Simon. I didn't expect it to be him. Fuck. Yeah, like, this will probably be a little easier for me because I sort of know a little bit about Rakugo. But we'll go from there. Yeah, I wasn't expecting... Because you gotta remember, Blackwell, he got absolved of his crimes in Dual Destinies. That's what happened at the end of Dual Destinies. He got absolved of his crimes, so... He doesn't need to be in jail anymore. He needs to just be out there, probably working with the court system. You needn't get so worked up, Athena. His baldness can wait. Do you have to, like, put on that? There's no way he'd wait for me. And besides, why would I want to start off on the wrong foot with him right out of the gate? Dealing with such matters is part of being a lawyer, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, well, covering you for your lateness is not. Still, but a rank amateur, I see. This is Simon Blackwell. He might not look it, but he's actually a prosecutor and a psychology specialist. He and I go way back. As for our shared specialization in psychology, we're both disciples of the same person, so to speak. But he's kind of my senior, I guess. But the twisted sense of humor or no, I wish he'd stop treating me like a child all the time.
So, where are Wright Dono and Justice Dono?
Mr. Wright's abroad, and Apollo is helping Trucy with her magic show. Didn't I tell you?
They're what?
So neither one of them are here, leaving you to take on this alone?
Yep.
Ye gods. Call Wright Dono back. It's not too late. Oh, no. It's too late. Not too late at all. He would need to know how to teleport. Very well.
Then I will settle for Justice Dono. Go grab him by the horns and drag him here.
Apollo is literally in the middle of a show right now, Simon.
You may not want to admit it, but I've got what it takes to take on this case.
Just leave it to me and go watch from the gallery.
As your defense derails in spectacular fashion.
No, as I win the heck out of this trial.
I'll be okay, promise. Swipe that look off your face already, will ya?
Anyway, I take it the guy behind you is... Yes, he's your... He's asleep again. Hoi, Bucky, wake up. What?
Ow. Why'd you do that for, Simi?
Why is he drunk as fuck early in the morning? Come on now. Alright, Lee. Thank you for stopping in. It was good seeing you. Have a good day. And I will see you next time I see you. Again, Simon sees Athena as a kid. I'm not surprised. Like, that sort of mentality came up. Like, I mean, the vibe came off as like protecting a little sister. Apparently he was passed out drunk, and then he bitch slapped a drunk with his like ninja sharp like hand cutter of justice. Actually, that brings a good question. Did they give him a sword back? If he's not a lawyer, if he's not in like in cuffs anymore, did he get his sword back? Hang on. Okay, we're still good. Battery's still good. Had to check.
Who's the yeller chickadee?
She's already the lawyer.
Such as it were.
Say she's more green than yellow, however.
Lawyer? She sure doesn't look it, does she? She like your fellow apprentice or something?
Something like that. I've known her longer than I've known you.
You could say that we're bound to one another. Oh, okay. Well then, guess I better call her Ms. Chickadee then.
Simon, that's not only rude, but he's three sheets to the wind at his own fucking trial. What in the fuck? Oh no! I'm not saying people didn't ship them. I'm just saying, like, I understand where they're putting his mentality at. In-game, at least. In-game, he sees her as the younger, as his younger sister that he has to protect, because how the fuck is she gonna do any of this if she's not ready for this? She's not ready. It's not time. She needs more training. She needs to do more stuff. She's not prepared. It's all of that stuff. She's acting like either a I guess you would either call it like you would have to call in this case like a doting brother, being very protective. I know we just met, but I'm about ready to give him a piece of my mind.
Do as you will, just save it for after the trial.
Ms. Jiggity. How'd you do? Simon here's an old friend of mine. I'm the fourth generation head chef of Wesoba. Wesoba, number four. Bucky Way. Nice to meet you.
He sobered up all of a sudden.
Hey, it's nice to meet you too, Mr. Wet.
So he can pull himself together when he wants to.
If only the trial wasn't starting in a few minutes.
Having been accused of murder that only occurred yesterday, I'm afraid it's taken a toll on the poor boy.
And you happen to be there at the theater where it all happened too, right? They say they found a Rakugo storyteller murdered in his dressing room.
Athena probably sees him as the annoying motherfucker who doesn't treat her like the lawyer that she actually is. And she sees him as a senior probably because they both do the psychological stuff. They've both been trained. They both were, like I said, effectively trained by the same person. She's probably trying to be like, prove him enough to be like, listen, back up off my nuts. I can do this. Trust me. Like, I am a lawyer. Watch me work. So.
Indeed. The victim, Master Storyteller, Typhoon Tornado
Fuck you guys, really?
Was a longtime patron of Wet Soba. Master Tornado had been looking after Bucky ever since Wet Noodle number 3 passed away.
Oh, I see, okay. So the victim was kind of like a father to the defendant, huh?
Dash stupid old fur. I got a father?
Nah.
This is always dishing my soba.
How dare you speak ill of him?
Running your mouth like that is why they suspected you of his murder in the first place. Now, pull yourself together. Number 3 must be rolling in his grave.
I still don't have a good voice for him. I don't know. I'm going to figure out how to do that if he's going to be in the case more.
Sammy. The police. None of them believes me. They won't listen to me.
It looks like he's still in shock from the whole ordeal. Don't worry, Mr. Wet. Everything's going to be all right. I'm going to defend you with everything I've got. You're in good hands now.
You mean, you believe me, ma'am?
Of course! No matter what, I believe in you to the very end.
Gee whiz, Miss Chickadee.
Now, come on, I need you to shape up. Just like those al dente noodles of yours.
Yes, ma'am. My soba is the freshest.
Oh, that was a terrible life choice. Why would you do that? And he's down! Mr. Wet! Bucky, you great big pillock. So, exactly how do you know this guy? I used to frequent Wet Soba. I still do, in fact. So I've known him since he was a lad. That's why his father and Master Tornado were always so good to me. I know you like soba so much, Simon.
I wouldn't expect one such as you, who eats meat slapped between slabs of bread, to understand the delicate taste and subtle texture imparted by buckwheat flour.
Hey, that's just rude.
But I digress.
I'm all about that flavor, and subtlety, and stuff. Oh no! Don't worry, he hasn't missed much. Roleplay, thank you for stopping in, man. I will see you next time I see you. Have a good night. There's nothing wrong with being a weeaboo. You gotta be passionate about something in life.
If I let Wet Soba end like this, I'll never be able to face number 3. Or Master Tornado in the next life.
Oh, okay, I see. And that's why you came to me. You wanted somebody you could trust.
It was never my intention to ask you.
I'll show him. Show him I can handle it just fine.
Well, I believe it's about time.
What? We haven't even properly discussed the case yet.
What's the matter? You look nervous, Athena.
Don't tell me you're chickadeeing out. I'm just trembling with the excitement of battle. That's all. Alright, I can't pronounce German worth a fuck, so... Aufgans? Sure, we're gonna go with it. Let's do this. Come, Mr. Wett. Get up off the floor. We've got a case to win.
Yes, Miss... Chickadee, I'm gonna do my best.
Wet soba, wet soba, wet soba, wet soba, wet soba.
I mean, I guess if that's your business, okay, for a phone, that's not bad. Hello. Two bowls of noodles? Sorry, sir, no can do. Kinda busy at the courthouse. Huh?
They hung up.
Okay, let's do this. He's not gonna do himself or his case any favors like this, Simon. Maybe we should let him go get some rest somewhere or something.
Hey, Mirish. Ha! Maybe if I was lumberero flour dough for your udon noodles. But I'm fresh, like my soba. You don't... Let soba dough rest.
It's all about the three freshes. Grind the buckwheat seeds fresh, cut the dough fresh, and boil the different burger. Fuck. I'm down again. Damn it. Fuck. He's blacked out. Oh boy. I just knew something like this would happen. Simon, what are these three freshes of soba he was talking about?
First, buckwheat seeds, or groats, are ground to make buckwheat flour. Then dough made with this flour is cut into a large rectangular knife into noodles. And finally, the buckwheat noodles are boiled. Each step is done immediately, one after the other, so that the soba is fresh when eaten.
Oh, that's what he meant. I wouldn't want him to make any soba right now, though, that's for sure. He used that long, thin, rectangular blade and, like, cut himself accidentally or something at this drunkenness state.
Athena, this is no time for idle chatter. You'll need to get into the courtroom now. Just remember, as a prosecutor, I will be unable to lend you a hand.
Don't expect any help from my quarter.
There you go, treating me like I'm incompetent again. For your information, I wasn't planning on asking you for help anyways. Just you wait, Simon. I'll show you. Mr. Wright and Apollo may not be here, but that's all right. I can do this on my own. Game, are you gonna... Oh boy. Alright. As much as I don't want to necessarily do this, this is actually a really good place to stop. So, peoples, that is going to be it for tonight. I'm gonna go ahead and call it here. This is a good place to stop. We just got through the entire thing that was the case 3. We're now in case 4. We have a good chance to do this. I will be casting tomorrow, probably around the same time, after dinner, in the evenings here. Probably no earlier than like 8:30-ish. But, if you enjoyed it and you want to see how case 4 goes through, definitely drop me a follow. You can hit the button right above my name right there. You'll get a notification when the channel goes live. You can come and check me out. We'll have a lot of fun. We'll go through case 4. Case 4, I've heard, is a little short, but that's fine. I can deal with the short case. If you guys have never been here before, I'm Seth the Second. I'm a variety broadcaster. I normally broadcast Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, starting at 8:45. As you can see, this is not Monday, Tuesday, or Thursday, so this is a normal extra cast. I do extra cast on days that are not Monday, Tuesday, Thursday when I have the time to do them. It kind of varies. I didn't put it on my normal schedule because I never know enough in advance if I have the time or not. If you want to know what I'm doing extra schedule cast, you can follow me on Twitter down below. The info, it's down in my info section down below. You can also check out my YouTube channel. My YouTube channel has all my past playthroughs, especially for stuff that's not on Twitch anymore because the VODs have expired. That's a good place to go for that. I will be uploading this VOD segment up on YouTube pretty much after I end the cast here. Anything else? I don't think there's anything else. We're going to try real hard to get through this game before, what is it, the 15th? Or the 25th? When, because I have a, so we got about a week, which means we probably have 1, 2, 3, 4, maybe 5, 6, 7 more casts to get through everything. So we might even do 2 segments tomorrow, depending on what happens in the afternoon. Because if I don't have anything going on in the afternoon, I'll probably just cast more, take a break for dinner, and then cast again. And then just restart the stream up again or do something with it. I don't know. We'll figure that out tomorrow as I go along. But like I said, all that will be put on Twitter. If you want to know when that's happening, you can either follow the channel to get the notification or follow or check out Twitter. Follow me on Twitter and find out when I tweet out about that. Well, no problem, Venomous Info. Or Venomous Lawyer. Wow, I read that very weirdly. I'm gonna get out of here, guys. Before I do, I need you to do me one kindness. I want you to have a good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good night, good day, whatever happens to be wherever you are at. And I will see you guys tomorrow for some more Phoenix Wright, where we find out about delicious, delicious soba noodles. See ya. Miss Laura, thank you for that follow. It is greatly appreciated, and you are awesome.